delicious buffet or something special from their menu. Remember Beverick's Friday Night Seafood Buffet, all you care to eat, just $14.95. They're open early for breakfast too, 6 a.m. Beverage Char House Grill at the I-16 exit Metter. Go Big Blue. Go Eagles.
At Sea Island Bank, we're passionate about Metter and Candler County. Whether it's our local schools and athletic programs, chamber events, or the Bloomin' Festival, you'll find our team members lending a helping hand. And if you need a financial partner, Billy Patterson and his staff are ready with local decisions, sound advice, and friendly service. Come see us today or visit us online at seaislandbank.com. We're passionate about our customers and the community we serve. Sea Island Bank, a division of Synovus Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Kick off the football and fall season with big savings from Badcock. Badcock Home Furnishings and More in Metter. Purchase a complete, beautiful 8-piece bedroom suit for just $1,598 and get a free, yes, we said free, widescreen HDTV. Swivel Chase Rockers, just $498. A 43-inch plasma TV, just $599.95. Ask about easy 24-month financing to make buying even easier. Badcock Home Furnishings and More, South Lewis Street, Metter.
James Penley, owner of Southern Pawn and Gold in Swainsboro, buys, sells, and trades just about anything. Jewelry, appliances, guns, tools, electronics, musical, and car stereo equipment. Cricket buys your gold at the best prices around. Cash your checks there, pay your bills. Car stereo installation, too. Southern Pawn and Gold, South Main, Swainsboro.
Sykes Brothers Incorporated, Metter, Vidalia, and Statesboro are ready to give you info on extending the life of your asphalt drives, parking areas, even streets. Call 685-6328. Grading, land clearing, excavating, and more. Sykes Brothers, Metter, Statesboro, and Vidalia.
The Countdown to Kickoff, presented by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Once again, from the Verizon broadcast booth, here is the voice of the Eagles, Chris Blair.
Good Saturday afternoon, and welcome to the prettiest little stadium in America as Georgia Southern begins its home slate here against the Tusculum Pioneers. Hello, everybody. This is Chris Blair alongside Terry Harbin, Ryan Chambers, Russ Brown, and the straw stirring the drink back in the studio, Tyler Manning, getting set to bring you the opening game here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium as Georgia Southern welcomes in out of Division II the Tusculum Pioneers. Of course, Georgia Southern and Tusculum meeting for the first time this afternoon. The Eagles off to a 1-0 start with a win over Samford in the conference last week, and Tusculum coming off a tough tussle with the West Georgia Wolves a week ago, getting the win 20-10. Frankie DeBusk, head coach of the Tusculum Pioneers, former Furman Paladin, who has a championship ring from 1988 and did not play in the 1989 National Championship game. So while many will see orange and black as Tusculum takes to the field, Georgia Southern fans will see purple. We're just about 12 minutes away from kickoff tonight. We'll take a timeout on the Countdown to Kickoff presented by State Farm Insurance. When we return, Terry Harbin, Ryan Chambers, they'll break down the offense and defense, Tusculum and Georgia Southern, here on the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
I'm in a state of caffeination, got all my fingers shaking, must have been my large Americano, mochino, macchiato. Now the family's gone to bed, and that's my favorite time to get some tips on better rates, because my State Farm guy answers late. And even when it's not my agent, someone's standing by so patient, getting coverage questions answered helps me to relax. Get to a better state, State Farm.
See Tom Boyd in Savannah, Krista Anderson in Dublin, and in Springfield, see Ronnie Brooks.
Fans Heritage Bank of the South is a proud supporter of Georgia Southern University. Just visit their location on Northside Drive next to Walmart in Statesboro, where Shirley Mincy and her team will offer fast, friendly, and efficient service. Heritage Bank of the South has a strong team of local leaders and local advisors because they believe in local decisions made by local people. Bank with those you know and trust. Bank with Heritage Bank of the South. Three area locations, 335 South Main Street, 201 South Main Street, and 726 Northside Drive.
Toyota doesn't need celebrities to help sell their cars. They'd rather let their owners do it. Wondering what your next car should be? Let a Toyota owner help you decide. Now get the 2011 Toyota Camry with 0% APR financing for 60 months, plus $500 customer cash. Monthly payment is $1,667 for every $1,000 financed through Southeast Toyota Finance. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and applicable dealer fees. Cannot be combined with other offers. Must complete retail sale and delivery between September 7th to 30th, 2011. There's no better time and no better vehicle. Hurry to your local Toyota dealer today because these deals won't last long.
So what does a good time sound like? Does it pack a punch?
This is for the UFC light heavyweight belt. Here we go!
or is it off the grid?
4 days, 3 nights, and absolutely no email. Ah, here we go.
A good time can sound like just about anything, but there's one sound that goes with a good time every time. Bud Light. Here we go. Please drink responsibly. Bud Light Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
This is the Countdown to Kickoff, presented by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Once again, from the Verizon broadcast booth, here is the voice of the Eagles, Chris Blair.
The hardest working band in show business on the field here at Alan E. Paulson Stadium, Southern Pride, under the direction of Dr. Colin McKenzie in his first year at the helm of Southern Pride. And we're in pregame on the Countdown to Kickoff as Georgia Southern welcomes in Tusculum for the home opener. To my right, high above the prettiest little stadium in America, Terry Harbin. And Terry, this is a Tusculum team, as we said, a Division II team, but one that's not afraid to jump up. Last year, 50-34, they went to Cullowhee, beat Western Carolina. Frankie DeBust, the head coach, he's been here before as a player. I think he's going to try to help his team not be intimidated by coming to Paulson today.
Oh, this is a big-time game for Tusculum, and they're going to come in with a high-flying offense or throw it all over the field, Chris. They got some big kids across the front, 6'4", 305, 6'4", 295. Even their tight end's huge, 6'10". They do like to throw the ball, not much of a running game, but they will wing it all over the place. Defensively, well, I'll let Ryan cover that one. Georgia Southern offensively, you know, Shaw on the field, he's like another coach. McKinnon's out there, too, and he's a highlight film in himself. Robert Brown had a great game last week with 140 yards on the ground. Just need to hold on to the ball. Our guys up front need to better, do a better job in the first half of exploding off the line of scrimmage and driving those guys back to open up the holes for Robert Brown. And, again, back to McKinnon with those quick pitches, getting around the corner. That's the best thing we can do on offense, and just don't turn the ball over, Chris.
Let's talk about defense. Don't know a lot about Tusculum. We know Georgia Southern, Ryan, last week got much better in the second half defensively between the lines tonight. What can we expect?
Well, let's start with what we know about Tusculum. 5 turnovers they get last week into that 20-10 win over West Georgia. Georgia Southern's got to keep the turnovers out. Tusculum's going to need turnovers to come out of Paulson with a win here today. They run the 3-3-5, which in that conference, the South Atlantic, everybody throws it. We've seen the 3-3-5 here. You got to imagine it'll be something similar to the dog that we've seen Samford run. They run 3 down linemen, 2 standing linebackers. It looks very much like the option we saw it halfway through the year last year, and a lot of teams started emulating something to watch the personnel. Are Tusculum even deep enough to be able to run in and out of that? The defensive line depth will certainly be an issue for Tusculum. For Georgia Southern, 5 DBs, and you talked with Coach Munkin, Chris, before the game about this. Michael Butler being back out on the field to have 5 DBs, he's going to be what's called the will. And we saw some big sticks from him last year, big hits, and that Appalachian State game being one of those examples. We'll see how the 5 DBs go. And then stopping third down. Tusculum was 5 of 6 on third down against Western the second quarter last year. That's really where they blew that thing away with 3 scores. Got to get off the field on third down, and I think with the throwing attack, a chance for Georgia Southern to get some quick turnovers, getting the offense back out on the field today, guys.
All right, Freedom about to make its flight from the top of the press box down to Glenn Bryant Field. We'll take a timeout, return, talk more about the matchup. Tusculum taking on Georgia Southern for the 2011 home opener. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football.
I'm in a state of caffeination, got all my fingers shaking, must have been my large Americano, mochaccino, macchiato. Now the family's gone to bed, and that's my favorite time to get some tips on better rates, cause my State Farm guy answers late, and even when it's not my agent, someone's standing by so patient. Getting coverage questions answered helps me to relax. Get to a better state, State Farm.
See John Mark Butler in Dublin, Philip Gay in Soperton, and Lee Girardo in Claxton.
Wall-to-wall football, crazy good food, and a whole lot of fun. That's what I call the Locos Triple Option. Jim Lanier and his team run it to perfection. Go up the gut with the new dry-rub, slow-roasted, fall-off-the-bone wings. Or pitch it to their always fresh and delicious field of greens. Or keep it around the end with one of their premium burger favorites from the Gridiron All-Stars. Oh, yeah, you'll scream, touchdown, Locos! Wall-to-wall football, crazy good food, and a whole lot of fun. Locos Grill and Puff, Statesboro. Locos, crazy good.
Harold promised his 7-year-old son, CJ, that he would build him a fort. That's why Georgia Power wants to be the official energy partner of keeping Harold's promise. Not only will we help Harold build that fort by supplying the reliable electricity he'll need, but we'll give him a blueprint to fortify his home and help save energy. It's called EarthSense. With EarthSense, he'll find energy savings he didn't know he had, and he can get hundreds of dollars back in rebates when he makes energy efficiency improvements to his home. To learn more about EarthSense, go to georgiapower.com. Georgia Power, official energy partner of you.
Southeastern Orthopedic Center is now Optum Orthopedics. With nearly 30 satellite offices, 3 Southeast Georgia hospitals, and a variety of additional physician practices, a new name was needed, Optum Orthopedics. The Eagles rely on Optum Orthopedics to get them back in the game, and you can rely on them to get you back into the game of life. Southeastern Orthopedics is now Optum Orthopedics. New name, but as always, their commitment to their patients is forefront with the focus on you. Optum Orthopedics.
The Countdown to Kickoff, presented by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Once again, from the Verizon broadcast booth, here is the voice of the Eagles, Chris Blair.
Celebrating 30 years of football here at Georgia Southern, the home opener for 2011. The Eagles making their way out of the locker room, about to make their way onto the field here as Tusculum still getting some last-minute tune-ups before they come out and get ready for the start of tonight's game. Good crowd on hand, but a slow arriving crowd. And what do you expect? It's Georgia Southern. It's the first home game of the season. Takes a while for everybody to get in the stands, but we expect a great crowd as Georgia Southern tries to move to 2-0. They'll have to do it against the Pioneers of Tusculum from Greenville, Tennessee. We'll return on the Countdown to Kickoff. Get this thing started. They'll boot the ball when we return. Georgia Southern and Tusculum here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium on the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Local owner Matt Reynolds at Sears in Swainsboro is ready to help with all your home and yard needs for the fall. From electronics to appliances and lawn equipment, you'll find it all. Before you buy anywhere else, be sure to shop prices at Sears, South Main in Swainsboro.
Hey, this is Statesboro Auto Sales, 489-5758. We will save you your money. Compare our prices on program off-lease cars. A 2010 Ford Fusion SE, over $3,000 less than the local dealers. And we do not advertise payments. We show you the whole price of the car. We help you watch out for your money. What better car dealer friend? Us, Statesboro Auto Sales.
At B&M Pool Spa and Patio in Metter, your pool is your paradise. So treat it right by installing or upgrading to the Totally Hayward system. With the Totally Hayward system, you get the best components designed to work together for optimal performance all season long. Hayward pumps, filters, heaters, cleaners, lighting, and controls keep your pool at its best. See your Hayward Select dealer because it's totally easy to be totally Hayward. B&M Pool Spa and Patio, North Leroy Street in Metter.
I know 0.0 about technology, but I did get a programmable thermostat. You know you can make it so the air's not running while you're gone, and when you get home, the house is still a perfect temperature. It feels really good when I'm paying the electric bill. I'm saving $280 a year just by pushing a few buttons. What can you do? Find out how the little changes add up at togetherwesave.com.
Canucci EMC, a touched home energy cooperative in Reidsville.
Chris Stanford at Stanford's Quality Collision Center in Twin City offers professional quality auto body repair at affordable prices. When you have an accident, large or small, get an estimate from Stanford's. They also do expert custom design painting. They'll make your vehicle look brand new. Check them out, Stanford's Quality Collision Center, Twin City.
You're listening to the flagship station of GSU Athletics, 103.7 The Boomer.
Today's broadcast is an exclusive copyrighted presentation of the Georgia Southern Radio Network. Thank you for listening and enjoy today's game.
Back here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium, just about set for the kickoff of the home opener here in 2011. Time now to introduce today's officiating crew, presented by Dr. Horace Dio and Professional Eye Care of Statesboro. Making the right call starts with taking care of your vision. Professional Eye Care of Statesboro is committed to providing comprehensive, high-quality vision care. Visit them online at drdeal.net. Dr. Horace Deal and Professional Eye Care of Statesboro, official team eye doctor of the Georgia Southern Eagles. Our officials today, referee Thomas Graham, the umpire Tillman Self, linesman Robbie Spires, line judge Greg Zimmerman, side judge Chris Rape, Field judge Ralph Green, and the bat judge is Jamie Tricoli. Eagles won the toss, defer until the second half, so Tusculum will receive the football to get things going here tonight. The Eagles dressed in their home blue jerseys, white bottoms, and of course Georgia Southern blue helmets for the visiting Tusculum Pioneers. They will be multicolored tonight, almost reminiscent of the early 80s Cincinnati Bengals. They've got orange on their shoulders, white jerseys, and black pants. There's no better looking team in America than the Georgia Southern Eagles. Keep your uniform looking great with Greener Cleaners in Statesboro, using a revolutionary and environmentally friendly dry cleaning service. Stop by at 510 Northside Drive East or find out more at burrowgreenercleaners.com.
As long as they don't do the icky shuffle in the end zone too much tonight, or whatever his name was, I'll be pretty happy with that. By the way, real quick, upset alert going on in the FCS right now. Folks, not making this up either. It's a whale of a ball game going into the fourth quarter. The start of the fourth quarter, Clemson 28, the Wofford Terriers 27, and the Georgia Bulldogs are up on South Carolina almost at half. It's 13-7. Georgia leads South Carolina.
Listen to Seth Harp talk to Mike Ayers yesterday afternoon. And Coach Ayers said as they went into Death Valley to take on Clemson, he just told the guys, don't watch them run down the hill. Forget all about the 80,000 at Death Valley and don't walk them. Watch them. We'll go down the hill and you'll be just fine. And apparently the coach was right in a tight game with a one-point Tiger lead.
I wouldn't want to be in Clemson, South Carolina if Wofford pulls that out today.
Time now for the first half kickoff presented by Heritage Bank of the South. With 20 locations across the state of Georgia and 3 convenient locations in Statesboro, Heritage Bank of the South committed to making local decisions by local people. And the kick from Billy Greer, fielded at the 10-yard line, coming the near side with a little bit of a seam across the 20 to the 25 before being dropped down there. And that's where Tusculum will take over, first down and 10. Decent return. Tusculum doing a good job. Terry is setting up a little bit of a wall there after fielding it at the 10-yard line.
Thankfully, it closed quickly, though. It wasn't a deep kick by Billy. Landed about between the 8 and the 10-yard line there. Not a lot of hang time on it, but our guys got down there. The flags are straight down. There's not a lot of wind on the field right now.
So Bo Cornell will bring out the Pioneer offense, the junior out of Cincinnati, Ohio. Loves to throw the ball around. He'll step into the shotgun. They'll have two receivers to the right, two to the short side of the field, and Cordell comes out firing right across the middle. Little trail route and complete up to the 35-yard line to Deontay Gist, a senior out of Welford, South Carolina, played at one of the most well-known high school programs in the country, James F. Burns High School in Duncan, South Carolina. Gist missed last week against West Georgia. Coach DeBusk and the company said they will go to Gist now that he's 100%. And no surprise, he makes it up to the 36-yard line. Pickup of 8 yards on the quick hitter to Gist.
Just a little dunk pass right across the middle underneath the linebackers. Good pickup. Loses his helmet, but gains 8 yards.
Two receivers right, two to the left side. Again, shotgun formation. He'll put it in the belly. It'll be Marcus Foster going around the right edge and making his way to the 40-yard line and picking up 4 yards, enough for the Tusculum first down. Blake Riley in on the stop. Defensive tackle, sophomore, 6'1", 278-pounder out of McIntosh County Academy.
Riley earning the starting nod last week during fall camp, I should say, beating out Tinsley. Both team really doesn't matter because both of them are getting a tremendous amount of playing time.
Tusculum off to the races here with 14 minutes just underway, first quarter. Shotgun snap again. Give it off to Foster, this time trying to squirt in the B gap, and Brent Russell shutting that down as he makes about a yard pickup to the 41-yard line, and that is all. Coach DeBus said this offense will be centered around, believe it or not Bogart Cordell, the quarterback, but rather Marcus Foster, the senior, 5'7", 180-pound running back out of Siloam, Georgia. Said everything comes from or built around what Foster can do with the football. Try to spread it out and then let Foster get the big gain. Second down and 9 at the 41. They'll flip it to Foster, right side, not a lot of room, trying to spread it out. Squirts his way to about the 43-yard line, only a pickup of 2. Derek Hyden in pursuit on defense for the Eagles.
Josh Gephardt did a good job of pushing that back in. Thought he was going to make a tackle for a loss there. Couldn't wrap up. Hyden coming up quickly, doing a job, only allowing him to gain 2 yards on the play.
Third down and 7 here. Tusculum, 5 of 14 last week for only 36%. Quick fire. in the flat right side and stopped at the 45-yard line. Carter with the catch. John Douglas with the blow. And Tusculum will be short of the first down. That will send out the punt unit. And Andy Rossetti, the sophomore out of Kent City, Florida, had a long of 45 yards last week. Six punts in that game. And the 2010 win over West Georgia, averaging 40 yards a kick.
John Douglas doing a good job smelling that screen. Fell back quickly and was able to make the tackle before he could pick up any more yardage.
Dominique Swope will stand back at the Eagle 10-yard line awaiting the kick from Rossetti, who stands at his 31. High snap, but he fields it. Kick is away. Knuckleball kick fielded at the 22 by Swope on the run. Far side 30, 35, cuts back at the 40, now makes his way across midfield, buries a Pioneer and makes it down to the Tusculum 40-yard line.
Wow, what a great return. I was actually a little worried with him coming up to field that ball, Ryan, like that,
yeah,
because that's where you see a lot of fumbles. But, Ryan, he just took off.
And he looked like he was going to call for the fair catch. If you saw his arm, I don't know that it was just a little bit of nerves. But, yeah, it knuckled, and I kind of saw the same thing, Terry, a little nervous that maybe it takes a deflection. The nerves of sitting in front of this crowd and catching that first one. What a return.
What a great job by a freshman.
Well, the thing you need to remember, neither you, Terry, nor Ryan or I have to field it. So maybe Dominique knows what he's doing. First down and 10. First offensive drive of the evening for the Eagles. Jabo Shaw under center, flexbone formation. Here's the quick toss. Jerick McKinnon starting A-back, going left side, makes his way down to the Tusculum 34-yard line. And Jerick McKinnon last week, 12 carries, 83 yards, had two rushing touchdowns. And you talk about an electric performance by the sophomore out of Marietta, Georgia. Whether he's in at quarterback in the Wildcat, whether he's under center at quarterback, or whether he is in the A-back slot, he is one to watch.
No doubt about it. Great run. It looked like they shut it down, but he ends up picking up 5 yards.
5 yard pickup. Second down, 5. They mark it just inside the 35-yard line of Tusculum. Eagles moving left to right. On the dive with a flag coming out. Jabo Shaw will give the handoff. Not much room on the left side to Robert Brown, and flags came out right at the snap, and it may have been Georgia Southern jumped early. We'll wait and see as we'll go to our referee, Thomas Graham.
I think we actually got him to jump on that left tackle.
Wait and see. A little more of a discussion there. Coach Frankie DeBusk wants an explanation, so they head to the far sideline.
They got some tall kids. Terrence Smith out there, senior. Offsides called against Tusculum. But I was talking about Terrence Smith, Ryan. He's a big kid, senior, 6'6", 240 pounds. Looks like he should be on a basketball court.
They do have some size, and I was surprised when I saw the depth chart come out this week. It's just the depth in the Division II. That's what we'll see as this game grinds on.
So the Eagles back on the field. Now the ball placed at the 30-yard line. First down and 10 after the infraction. Shaw under center. Brown, your B-back. McKinnon in motion left side. Give it off. Shaw will keep it, actually, and dive around the left side, make it down to the 25-yard line. Right now, Georgia Southern 5 yards a clip on the ground with 10:57 to play. No score. Opening drive for the Eagles after forcing a punt from the Tusculum Pioneers.
No surprise that they're playing Tusculum with that more classic 4-3 look. We'll see how comfortable they are in that. Like we said in the open, 3-3-5 is the personnel set that they've run out there and coming out early in that 4-3-3 classic standing linebackers.
Send out Williford wide to the right side. Contrellis Showers, a wide receiver, to the left. Scrimmaging from the left side, or rather left hash, as Shaw takes out, looking. Looking for Zach Walker, the freshman receiver down the left sideline. In his hands, couldn't hold on. Pretty good coverage down there for the Pioneers. Step for step, Kent Agby was right there with him.
I like the pass by Shaw. He threw it behind him, but Zach Walker had his eyes on it the whole time. Tried to push off the receiver a little bit, or the defensive back, to make the play on it. And he couldn't. But, you know, that's the M.O. of Zach Walker.
Yep.
Is he knows how to go after that ball. I got a chance to visit with Don Norton, the head coach of Johnson County, who coached him. And that's what he said. Zach Walker will find the ball and bring it down.
So the Eagles go for the strike through the air on second down. They'll look at 3rd and 5 now at the Tusculum 25. Again, attacking left to right on your dial. Shaw on the flex bone. J.J. Wilcox, an A-back along with McKinnon. Give it off to Robert. Nope. Fake it. Shaw's free. 15, 10, 5. Left side. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. What a beautiful fake, and Tusculum bit. Everybody went after Robert Brown. Unfortunately, J-Bo Shaw for the Pioneers was running the other way. The Eagles take the early lead 6-0 with 10:16 to play here in the first quarter. Beautiful play by J-Bo Shaw.
Ryan, we blew open that left side of the line.
They didn't have a chance. And I was staring right at it, boy. That hole was 10 feet wide if it was a foot.
Wow. So now Adrian Moore on for the point after. Charlie Edwards to hold. Here's the snap, the set, the kick. It's on its way. Kick by Moore is up and good. Georgia Southern opening drive down the field. They lead 7-0 here in the first quarter. We'll take a timeout. Step away for a moment. You're listening to Eagle Football.
Mark Lee at Kawasaki of Statesboro is ready to help you ride into fall with great savings on every Kawasaki motorcycle or Kawasaki mule in the store. Get ready for fall riding with a new Kawasaki. Check prices before you buy. See Kawasaki of Statesboro, Highway 80 east of the mall.
Stateview Mini Storage Manor and in Twin City, behind the Time Saver, offers climate control, fenced in, lighted, camera monitored storage buildings. Also, Wayne Supply Twin City specializes in newer replacement of windows and doors. Call John Wetzel, 478-763-2319.
Bales Transmission and Service in Statesboro does more than repair transmissions. They're now a full-service auto mechanic shop with easy financing and towing available. Student and commercial discounts, too. Bales Transmission and Service, Cypress Lake Road on the bypass just up from 301 South, Statesboro.
Tom Flanders at Handy House Manufacturing in Swainsboro has the answer to all your storage needs. Stop by and see their big selection of all-size storage buildings. Make a purchase or use their easy-to-rent-own program. Handy House Manufacturing, South Main, Swainsboro. They'll cover what you want to keep safe.
Welcome back to the Verizon broadcast booth. Chris Blair, Terry Harbin, Ryan Chambers, and Russ Brown along with you. And Georgia Southern with 10:16 to play in the first quarter, up 7-0 over the Tusculum Pioneers. And look pretty good on offense. A little bit of difference between the opening drive last week, Terry Harbin, and this afternoon.
It certainly was, and it's a lot more comforting. I like this approach a little bit better than what we saw against Samford, and didn't eat up a whole lot of clock, just a minute 50. Only four plays. Of course, they started on the 40-yard line thanks to a great punt return by Swoop. Four plays, 40 yards. Shaw keeps it around the left side. The offensive line opens it up wide open for him, and he walks in the end zone untouched. Put an Eagle 6 on him. The Eagles score at the 10-16 mark to go up 7-0. That's your Toyota game tracker.
10-16 to play, first quarter. Billy Greer will tee it up at the Eagle 30-yard line. Jonathan Deliberto is back deep for the Pioneers, awaiting the kick. Here's the approach. Greer boots this one. Line drive kick and fairly deep. Fielding it at the goal line. Coming from the far side up the middle of the field. Again, a decent seam and a shoestring tackle unable to wrap him up as he makes it to the 26-yard line. Tusculum again will start with pretty good field position. Not bad so far in their first two kick returns, Terry, and getting decent yardage.
Again, a decent kick by Billy. Not quite as high, but Atlanta at the goal line made you think about it. Tusculum did a great job of opening up that left side, but Brent Thomas thankfully came in there and made the tackle. Brent Thomas, the 5'10", 192 senior out of Tampa, Florida, got a chance to visit with his mother and dad for the game.
10:09 to play, first quarter, 7-0. Georgia Southern with the lead. Bo Cordell brings out the troops offensively. Stands in the pocket, fires far side. Catch going to be made by Brian Marshall, who finds some room down the far sideline, picks up huge yardage into Eagle territory. A first down for the Tusculum Pioneers. Let's take a look at the Optum Health Orthopedic injury update for the Eagles. Let's go down on the field and Ryan Chambers.
Obviously, as we mentioned last week, Deion DeBose and Darian Robinson not dressing, but those dressed out in blue and white, all's a go, according to Robbie on the sidelines.
Marked him out of bounds at the 43-yard line of their very own.
Gephardt
Marshall on the carry right up the gut.
Gephardt doing a good job of tripping him up. And on that previous play, by the way, it was Gephardt on coverage on Brian Marshall. A little bit of a mismatch, if you ask me.
I think there was a bust in coverage there.
So now looking at second down and 7 after Marshall with the carry. They'll stack receivers left and right. Here's the double pump pass to Marshall in the backfield. And Marshall somehow in traffic, makes his way into Eagle territory at about the 48-yard line and very close to a Tusculum first down, maybe shy by maybe half a yard. In fact, the near side spot says he's at the first down sticks. We'll wait and see.
Looked like it was Tinsley on the tackle on that one back into the ball game. Roger Tinsley able to bring it down, but not before he was able to get the first down as they're signaling it, but yet the sticks aren't moving. There we go.
Okay.
So now a first down granted to the Tusculum Pioneers.
On our side of the field.
Down 7-0 here early, but now moving on their second drive of the evening. Cordell out of a shotgun again. Receiver stacked back behind each other. Setting up the screen. Far side pass and finding something in the tunnel.
Wow.
I don't know how he got through that one, Chris. It was a load of Eagles there trying to make the tackle.
Deontay Gist on the tunnel screen makes his way down inside the 45. That's what you can expect from Tusculum tonight. It's a lot of short passes. Trying to get Gist as well as Brian Marshall and Marcus Foster involved in space. Third down and 6 at the Eagle 44. Shotgun snap. Cordell looking left. Now decides to tuck and run. Nowhere to go. And he's dropped at the 46-yard line by Brent Russell. Bo Cordell, Harlan Hill Trophy candidate, just met the Buck Buchanan candidate for the FCS. Juwan Minchin also in on the tackle for the Eagles. And that will set up a third down and 8 here for the Pioneers, down 7-0 with 8:03 to go in the first quarter.
Great pressure, and they did a good job. When they saw him tuck and run, they did a fantastic job of folding back down. Loss on the play. Here we are, 3rd and 9.
Again, they'll stack receivers left and right. Working from the right hash, attacking right to left. Shotgun snap, Cordell looking left all the way. Fires into the flat, near side, and Rodriguez hauls it in. But Riyad Jones, the freshman out of Columbus, Georgia, wraps him up quickly, well shy of the first down. It'll set up 4th and about 5, maybe a long 5, maybe 6. And we'll see what Tusculum decides to do. Got nothing to worry about if you're Coach Frankie DeBusk. You're not supposed to compete in this game. You're Division II taking on Division I. I would not put anything past this Pioneer team. Also, even with the punting formation and Andy Rossetti standing at the Tusculum 43-yard line to kick it away to Dominique Swope. Swope had a great return on the first punt of the night. Rossetti will kick it away. This time gets plenty of foot into this one. It'll sail into the end zone for a touchback, and Georgia Southern will take over. First down and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Good punt. Very good punt. Kicked in the end zone. That's one way of taking care of Swope. And, you know, on that last play there, it's funny you had Blake Riley backing off the line of scrimmage, taking the crossing pattern. But Riyad Jones did a fantastic job of breaking on the ball. And then that open field tackle last week, the difference of 1 week, Chris. Last week, we missed that tackle. Remember? We had a lot of open field missed tackles just like that.
20 missed tackles in the game last week. Something that was not lost on Coach Munkin and Coach Curtis when practice began at Eagle Creek earlier this week. Out come the Eagles. First down and 10 at their very own 20-yard line. They lead 7-0 here against Tusculum with 6:55 to go in the first quarter. Jabo Shaw in the flexbone formation. Jarek McKinnon, J.J. Wilcox, your A-backs. Robert Brown, your B-back. Ball middle of the field. Here's the snap. Ball on the carpet. Put it in the belly of Brown, but I don't think it was a clean exchange. And Jabo Shaw diving back to the line of scrimmage right at the 20 to keep possession for Georgia Southern.
Yeah, Ryan, it looked like when he was pulling it out of Robert Brown, he kind of hit it on the hip.
Yeah, it looked like it caught the hip as he was turning left down the line of scrimmage, and he just caught it. But good to get it. He didn't pick it back up and try to make a play out of it.
Second down, 10 from the 20-yard line. Now from the far side hash. Jabo under center. They'll motion Wilcox left to right. Option near side. Wilcox on the run. 25, 30. Lowers the shoulder across the 35. And dropped at the 38-yard line. Big pickup for J.J. Wilcox. It's a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. Good to see J.J. really dominant in this offense. A huge part of the offense a year ago. Very quiet night in Birmingham a week ago.
Sure it was. And on that one, we saw a little bit of Wilcox's speed on the corner and his toughness as he put his head down and took out the tackler on his way down to get the first down.
Patrick Barker lines up wide out left side. Contreras showers to the near side. First down and 10 at the 39-yard line of the Eagles. Again, Wilcox in motion. They'll fake the quick toss, and Shaw stands back in the pocket, fires, looking for Showers. Caught at the 23 and brought down at the Tusculum 14-yard line. T.J. Jones on coverage, and Showers had to step down the middle of the field, and a perfectly thrown ball by J-Bo Shaw.
And a perfectly executed play-action fake. He sucked in the linebackers, was able to get that step. He took off in that post pattern, delivered a perfect pass, good catch by the freshman. Wow, what a great play.
First down and 10, now at the Tusculum 13-yard line. Receiver out wide to the left, flex bone formation, Shaw under center. They'll motion Wilcox, quick toss, near side. Wilcox got a great block to the 10, to the 5. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Jarek McKinnon laid the block to spring Wilcox free. And it's 13-0 with 5:26 to go here in the first quarter.
Well, you know, Ryan, you talk about McKinnon's speed. Did you expect to see that, or is that offseason workout?
Well, you hope you get to see some of that after the outside game wasn't the strongest set coming away from Birmingham, and that only means that middle game, that B-back up the middle, should be strong from this point forward.
More on for an extra point here with a 13-0 game in Georgia Southern. Doing as they please offensively. Morris kick up, and it is good. 14-0 our score here. Georgia Southern leads over the Tusculum Pioneers. 5:26 to play, first quarter action. We'll return. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Okay, it's game day, where tradition runs deeper than your Aunt Betty's baked beans. Face paint? Check. Cooler? Check. Meat for the grill? Check. Ford F-150 with best-in-class towing, payload, and a V6 EcoBoost engine delivering 22 mpgs. Check, check, and check. Now check this. Go to shopfordnow.com to find great offers on F-150 from your local Ford dealer. Fans of Georgia Southern football. EK estimated 16 city, 22 highway mpg, 3.5 liter V6 4x2.
At BB&T, sharing financial knowledge is our responsibility, our privilege, and our legacy. For more than 135 years, BB&T has been sharing the knowledge our clients need to move in a brighter financial direction. We also share a commitment to our community, supporting our schools, arts, and sports programs, helping businesses grow and families become homeowners. Because when you share knowledge, you share so much more. BB&T, sharing knowledge for a brighter direction.
Member FDIC, loan subject to credit approval, equal housing lender.
Georgia Southern True Blue, defined as diehard, enthusiastic, lifetime supporters of Georgia Southern University. Are you True Blue? Well, you can join the Alumni Association today. Visit alumni.georgiasouthern.edu or call 912-GSU-ALUM. 5:26 to go, first quarter action here from Allen E. Paulson Stadium, home opener for 2011. And the Eagles up 14-0 over the Tusculum Pioneers. And something tells me, Terry, there's flashbacks going on in the head of Frankie DeBus right now. He's seen this before.
Yeah, a lot of Eagle fans have seen this before, and they're certainly glad to see it back. Folks, we touched the ball two times. Both series, 4 plays each. This series, 4 plays, 80 yards, took a minute 29 to score. Wow, great pass. It was set up with a great pass to Showers across the middle on play action, and then McKinnon throws a great block as Wilcox takes it around the right side. 13 yards out for a touchdown. The Eagles up 14-0 here.
And Terry, you remember when we knew that J.J. Wilcox had become an official running back, was on that very almost same play against West Georgia. The opener here last year against Savannah State going into the end zone. Similarly, the opening touchdown for Wilcox in 2011 right down the same sidelines into the end zone.
8 plays, 115 yards on the day for Georgia Southern. We're averaging 14.4 yards per play, and that's your Toyota game tracker, Chris.
So the Eagles will tee it up once again, kicking it back left to right. Greer kicking with the wind behind him here. Marcus Foster and Jonathan Deliberto back deep for the Pioneers. They've had two great returns and have gotten into Eagle territory, but drives have stalled there. Short kick. Deliberto will field it at the 13-yard line near side. He's looking to the near sideline, breaks off an arm tackle, and makes his way to the 25. Flag on the field. We'll see what it's all about. Again, our official today, referee Thomas Graham.
That one came from the back judge back there where Billy was. Back near the kicker is two of the Tusculum players. We're both blocking the kicker, Billy Greer. Again, we go with a short kick to the right, away from their speedster. They've had two great returns already on the day. They've had three returns on the day for 56 yards, Tusculum has.
Marcus, so go ahead.
We have a meeting of the minds here at the 25-yard line. And again, stands starting to pack in. And in fact, you look across the way, you see fans making their way. We got plenty on the grass here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium, as Thomas Graham will tell us what it's about.
An illegal block, Chris, below the knees against Tusculum is going to back him up.
Chris, you and I are here since 2006, but Terry, you've been here forever. Is it me or is the student section grow by about 25% every year?
I think in particular this year, and you could go back to the
it
efforts of Dr. Keel and this university really calling out these students and getting them out here for a ball game.
And this place is slammed on this side, and it has been since kickoff.
I'll tell you, it's the MC of day one.
That's right.
Of day one that got them out today. So Tusculum takes over after the infraction. First down and 10 at their own 12. Quick fire, and they got some room for Michael Rodriguez, the tight end, who makes his way up just shy of the 20-yard line, far side. LaRon Scott coming up for the stop. Rodriguez comes into the game, had 12 receptions last week against West Georgia. Rodriguez, a busy man with 98 yards out of Columbia, South Carolina, product of Hargrave Military Academy. First down here for the Pioneers. They'll come out, set up the screen once again, far side. And a lot of running room. Missed tackles again. We'll find Rashad Carter up to the 30-yard line. It's about a 17-yard gain. It'll set up first down and 10 for the Pioneers. John Douglas on the stop,
along with Derek Hyden as well, coming in there and breaking a lot of tackles, but also give credit where credit is due. Showing a lot of elusiveness there by the senior out of Stone Mountain.
First down and 10 now at the Tusculum 30-yard line. Cordell ready to get working. Two receivers left, two to the right. Looking left all the way. In the pocket, has time. Now flushed out, running, and brought down from behind at the 30-yard line by Josh Gebhardt. Had a sack last week. And that time, Gebhardt showing his speed. Caught Cordell from behind. And it looks like he got no gain, no loss, no harm on the play. It'll set up second down and 10 at the Tusculum 30-yard line.
What a great job of blocking, though, that offensive line did. But that's credit to our defensive backs. Did a good job of covering. He didn't have anybody to throw to, and when he stepped up, the pocket collapsed, and he got chased down.
Two receivers right, two to the left side, wide side of the field. Snap to Cordell. Looks to slowly throw downfield. Derek Hyden may have hauled it in at midfield. He does. Hyden with his second interception of the season. Brent Russell put Bo Cordell down in the backfield. And Cordell, love to have that one back. Looked very nonchalant in the pocket. Then just kind of tossed to the far sideline. And Derek Hyden saw it first. And Hyden with his second interception. That is the third for the Eagle defense this year. And with 4 minutes to play in the first quarter, Georgia Southern will take over at their very own 49-yard line.
And the second one by Hyden. And Ryan, on that play, Hyden turned into a wide receiver. Great steps there at the sideline.
He did. And I think Cordell was sensing. We're getting more and more pressure from the tackles every single play. And I think Cordell was sensing he was running out of time.
So back up in the Eagle offense. First down and 10 at the 49-yard line. Shaw under center, flex bone formation. Nico Heckey checked in now as an A-back. Motion Wilcox, Shaw, late pitch. Wilcox near side across midfield. Now stutter steps and lowers the shoulder down to the 44-yard line. So Wilcox so far tonight already being a very integral part of this Georgia Southern offense.
Nico Heckey taking out two blockers on that one. One he meant to, and the other, well, he didn't mean to, but regardless, he took two of them out.
Fred Walker on the stop for the Pioneers, senior out of Danville, California. Working from the right hash now. Second down and three for the Eagle offense. They'll send a receiver out and Showers to the left side. Barker to the near side. Put it in the belly of Robert Brown. Bounces off the left side and gets free. He's to the 30. A flag comes out late as Robert Brown eventually tripped up at the 21-yard line. It's enough for a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles. That flag coming from the defensive backfield from about the 15-yard line. We'll see what it's all about. But Robert Brown, so impressive last week in the win, 140 yards carry, as you said, and just looks to be running. You and Ryan talked about it in the broadcast last week. Looks totally different from a year ago.
That shows his strength, and you go give credit to Melton and his crew in there doing such a good job. But unfortunately, I believe that great run is going to be called back as the Eagles are heading back, and Coach Monken not very happy with the call right now as he's being asked to step back to the sideline. And he's giving him an earful, Chris. He's giving him an earful. Bless his heart.
Coach Melton does a lot more things other than strength and conditioning very well, if you keep an eye out on the sidelines.
It's that new call this year, Chris, the new rule on blocking below the knees, and Coach Monken not liking it.
We had plenty of boos for that call in Birmingham, a few thousand more here at Statesboro tonight. So that will back the Eagles up after a huge gain, and Coach Monken not happy at all. He is still continuing to be in the ear of the official near sideline.
Well, it's got to be within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage of where the ball is, and also you have that near blocker. So that's certainly open to some interpretation. Apparently, Coach Monken interprets it a little bit different than the field judge does. But moving on.
Still manageable. Second down and three. The ball at the Tusculum 43-yard line. Near side hash. Shaw under center, flexbone formation. They fake McKinnon in motion. And they'll give it off, and Tusculum staying at home to Robert Brown as Dustin Lane from Lithonia, Georgia, the sophomore, makes the stop. And maybe a loss of a half yard. It'll set up third and a long three here for the Eagle offense. Georgia Southern up 14-0. 2:28 to play here in the first quarter from Allen E. Paulson Stadium.
They bring in Sumner into the ball game. And on this defense, they got a four-man front. They're taking their middle linebacker there and walking him up almost in a blitzing scenario. I'm surprised about how deep the other two linebackers are playing, almost back there with the safety.
Zach Walker in now as a wide out left side. Set the tight end formation. Shaw under center. Brown your B-back. Hickey and McKinnon your A-back. Shaw going to have to keep. And Tusculum covers him up. Stopped at the 45-yard line by Boomer Brown, the inside linebacker out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And the first fourth down situation for the Eagles offense will bring out Charlie Edwards to punt it away. Charlie, a good night last week in Birmingham. Four punts, 43-yard average. Had a season-long 45 yards a week ago. A chance to pin back. This is where you go to your punter, Terry, and I'm not telling you anything you don't know, but you go to him here and say, you've got plenty of leg. Let's pin him deep.
Beautiful punt. It looks like he may have done that as he hung this one up high. He just needs a pitching wedge out of it, and it goes about 2 yards into the end zone, Chris. He hung it up there nice and high, just about 5 to 8 yards too far.
So a touchback will put Tusculum first down and 10 at their own 20-yard line with a minute 23 to play here in the first quarter. Georgia Southern up 14-0. Had the opportunity to host our radio affiliates today and had all of them come in from across the state of Georgia. Chance to meet with some of them. Certainly happy to have them here today, and certainly happy to have them each and every Saturday on the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Always a coaching opportunity as Coach Monken talks to Charlie as he comes off the field about angling that punt a little bit differently there. But Coach Monken, always a coach, even during those situations, to pull the punter off.
First down and 10 at the 20-yard line. Cornell, shotgun snap. Again, lazy throw, and this one in and out of the hands of Brian Marshall, the junior out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. And when I say lazy, what I'm saying is Cornell goes back, doesn't even have his arm up. He just looks so confident back there that he's not hurried at all and really put it on the money. Marshall just dropped it.
And thankfully, he did, because Kyle Albeck on that had coverage and fell, and he was wide open, and that was a lot of green in front of him. So thankfully, he just had brick hands.
Trip receivers near side. Cordell out of a gun. Looking right, looking across the middle, and this time in the hands of Rashad Carter. He can't hold on. It'll set up third down and 10 from the 20-yard line. And if you're Bo Cordell, the junior out of Cincinnati, Ohio, might get in that huddle and talk to your receivers just a little bit.
Yeah, they haven't helped him out too much on these last two plays. Again, good crossing route. A lot of underneath. You saw Boise do that a good bit against Georgia last week.
Oh, you saw that?
Saw the highlights of it, put it that way.
Third down and 10 at the 20-yard line. Tusculum down 14-0 here with a minute 16 to go. It's been a quick drive through two downs so far. Cordell sends Marshall in motion, and at the snap, flags fly, and it looks like somebody jumped up front for the Pioneers.
Too many people in motion at the same time. That'll throw a flag every time.
So this may back up the Pioneers, looking at second down, or rather third down and 15.
Speaking of Georgia, South Carolina leads them in the third quarter, 14 to 13.
Don't know if anybody expected that game to be that low scoring, to be honest with you.
No, not after you saw what South Carolina did last week, putting on some offense later on. But
third and 15 now for the Pioneers, backed up to their own 15-yard line. Down 14 to nothing, a minute 15 to play, first quarter. Cordell out of a gun, Marceau on a wing to his right. Steps back, three steps, looking down the far sideline, unloads, and this one's hauled in at the 45 by Deontay Gist. What a catch to give the Pioneers new life in this drive. First down and 10. They'll say just shy of midfield at the 49.
Well, you knew they could. You know they could throw the ball, and it was a great route, a good pass, a little fall down on coverage by Hayden on that one, but he made a good job of holding on to the ball.
So for the third time today, the Pioneers on the Eagles' side of the field. Quick screen to Gist, far side, cuts back inside and gets to the Eagle 48-yard line. Pickup of three, Darius Eubanks on the stop for the Eagles. Set up second down and 7 here for the Pioneers as wholesale changes come in for the Eagle defense. Brent Russell back on the field.
Josh Rowe, the initial man to make the tackle, missed the tackle on that play. It slowed him up just enough for Eubanks and crew to get over there.
Second down, 7. At the Eagle 48-yard line, Cordell out of a gun. Marceau on a wing to his right. Cordell in trouble and brought down by the ankles. Michael Butler comes in. Second sack of the season for Butler. And a huge play will deflate the confidence of the Pioneers. Now back on their side of the field at the 43.
Good call by Curtis there, Ryan. He did it last week with Butler. He pulls it again today.
And I mentioned in the pregame, he is listed at the wheel in this 5 defensive back set. We saw so many big sticks out of Butler. He's a guy that likes to play up front. Very good against the run. You can certainly use him in those situations as well.
That's the end of the first quarter here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium with your score. Georgia Southern 14, Tusculum nothing. We'll return. The Pioneers stare down a third down at 17 when we return to the prettiest little stadium in America. You're listening to Georgia Southern football.
Kick off the football and fall season with big savings from Badcock. Badcock Home Furnishings and More in Metter. Purchase a complete, beautiful 8-piece bedroom suit for just $1,598 and get a free, yes, we said free, widescreen HDTV. Swivel Chase Rockers, just $498. A 43-inch plasma TV, just $599.95. Ask about easy 24-month financing to make buying even easier. Badcock Home Furnishings and More, South Lewis Street, Metter.
I know 0.0 about technology, but I did get a programmable thermostat. You know you can make it so the air's not running while you're gone, and when you get home, the house is still a perfect temperature. It feels really good when I'm paying the electric bill. I'm saving $280 a year just by pushing a few buttons. What can you do? Find out how the little changes add up at togetherwesave.com.
Canucci EMC, a Touchstone Energy Cooperative in Reidsville. 103.7 The Boomer.
Back to the Verizon broadcast booth here high above Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Chris Blair, Terry Harvin, Ryan Chambers, Russ Brown along with you. Start of the second quarter, 14 to nothing. Georgia Southern with the lead. Teams change sides of the field. And Tusculum staring at third down and 17 at their very own 43-yard line. Huge sack by Michael Butler at the end of the first quarter. After Tusculum converted on a huge third down to keep the drive alive.
Real quick scoring update. It's a final up in South Carolina at Clemson. Clemson 35, the Wofford Terriers 27. They gave them a ball game. A little bit of a scare. The Tigers pull out a victory.
Very close to the score last week. Wofford winning over Presbyterian in their season opener. Cordell out of a gun. Two receivers to the right side. Cordell, slight pump fake, and now pocket collapses. Josh Gebhardt lays down Cordell back at the 32-yard line. And that will set up fourth down and a cab ride. And on comes the punting unit, Andy Rossetti, for the Pioneers with 14:41 to go here in the second quarter.
Give credit also to Bailey. New into the ballgame out of Lula, Georgia. Defensive tackle came in, putting pressure on his guy, pushing his guy right in back of him. He made, opened up the door for Gephardt to make the sack.
Dominic Swope down at the 25-yard line, trying to put his hand up to block the sun, which is coming in on him here as Rossetti will kick it away from the 20. Here's the kick, high kick Swope trying to inform the Eagles where it is. Takes an Eagle bounce, and Tusculum will down it at the 37-yard line. And Georgia Southern takes over with 14-10 to play here in the second quarter of action. Georgia Southern football presented in part by Bud Light. Bud Light reminds you that responsibility matters and to always designate a driver. Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Bud Light, here we go. So here come the Eagles offense. Jabo Shaw and company will march out on the field. Attacking right to left now in the second quarter. Will scrimmage from the far side hash. Receiver out short side. One receiver to the left side. And Contrellis Showers. Patrick Barker out wide to the right. Robert Brown near B-back. Jerick McKinnon and J.J. Wilcox lined up in the offensive backfield. First down and 10 from the 36. Shaw pulls it and is dropped back at the 34. Just shy of the 35-yard line as Luke Harris out of Floyd, Virginia, the junior, coming up to make the stop on Jabo Shaw.
Luke Harris doing a good job of staying with the quarterback on that play, which is what you got to do, and he drops him for about a one-yard loss on the play.
Break from the huddle. Brandavius Mann will line up, put his nose over the football. Showers again to the left. Barker to the right side. McKinnon, Wilcox, and Brown in the offensive backfield. Option right side. Shaw decides to keep. It's a little bit of room on that right side to about the 37-yard line before Luke Harris again on the stop.
Last two series, Tusculum has made some defensive adjustments. Done a good job of stopping the option here. Good pursuit.
They're running more similar to what we saw last week out of Sanford, except they're moving the safety over the top. They're moving him over, almost over the nose tackle. So they're giving up everything behind the defensive backs if they were to be able to throw Georgia Southern.
Third down and 9 at the 37 for the Eagles. Two receivers as they put McKinnon in a slot near side. Shaw comes out, fires far side, and it's incomplete. Coming back for it was Showers, but good coverage by Tusculum. Got a hit on the receiver, and it's incomplete for fourth down. T.J. Jones coming up and took down Showers right at the delivery of the football. And Charlie Edwards on once again to punt it away.
No, it was a great play by T.J. Jones. He knew what was coming. He sniffed it out, played it well. Poorly thrown ball. Showers had to go up for it, took his legs out. Charlie, we need a big punt from you now.
He stands at the 21, kicks it away. Rashad Jones back deep. This one a short punt. Takes a bounce at the 25, and Georgia Southern will down it at the 20-yard line. So Tusculum takes over, first down and 10 at the 20 with 12:40 to play here in the first half. 14-0, Georgia Southern with the lead. Fans, for all of your gas up and tailgate supply needs, it's Neighbors Express with locations in Statesboro in front of Lowe's. Also in Sylvania and Exit 51 in Dublin on your way in to the heart of Eagle Nation. Choose to do business with those that are true blue. Choose Neighbors Express convenience stores.
43-yard punt by Charlie Edwards. Most of that on the roll. You're going to have a miss, much in golf. You'll take a good miss anytime. That right there was a good miss, and Charlie will take it. Nice roll.
Tusculum back on the field. First down and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Cordell out of a shotgun. Steps back. Has time. Now decides to tuck and run. Coming near side, then cuts back in the middle of the field. Makes it to the 24-yard line, just shy of the 25, as Deion Stanley gets the stop. Stanley last week, Southern Conference, or this week, I should say, Freshman of the Week. Made a great over-the-top deflection early in that first half against Sanford that really kind of set the tone for the second half defensively for Georgia Southern. Finished with 10 tackles in the game.
Did a good job of taking on a defensive tackle, a 6'1", 290-pounder.
4-yard pickup by Cordell. Shotgun snap. Quick fire, far side. Catch made by Rodriguez. He tries to get to the far sideline near the first down sticks. Brought out of bounds near the 28-yard line. Appeared to be about a yard and a half shy of the first down. LaRon Scott on coverage and brings him down for the stop. Georgia Southern scored with 10:16 to go in the first quarter. Jabo Shaw, a 25-yard touchdown run. Moore with a point after to make it 7-0. Then with 5:26 to go in the first quarter, J.J. Wilcox scored from 13 yards out. And the Eagles up 14-0 here. Looking at third down and 2 at the 28-yard line. High snap to Cordell. He'll give it off. Fred Jones. Actually, Michael Rodriguez on the far side got the screen pass, and he's up to the 30, and it appears to be enough for a first down. Darius Eubanks on the stop. But a pretty good job by Cordell and the running back for the Pioneers Almost appeared towards a Southern bit, and a quick fire comes out far side, and it's enough for the first down for Tusculum here with 11-16 to play. Second quarter.
Just 2 of 6 on third down conversions. Westbrook's getting some playing time this week after missing last week's ballgame.
Cordell out of a shotgun. Three receiver setup. Near side, one to the left side. Quick fire across the middle again. In the hands and incomplete to Xavion Smith.
LaRon Scott coming in on a corner blitz, just taking out Bo Cordell as he released that ball. And Cordell a little bit slow to get off, but a good blitz by LaRon Scott on a corner blitz.
Tusculum now looking at second down and 10 after the incompletion. Cordell shouting instructions here from the 30-yard line of their very own. Down 14-0 to the Eagles here. 11 minutes even to play, first half. Cordell trying to buy time. Now comes out of the pocket up the middle of the field, and he's brought down by Josh Gebhardt, who has been all over Cordell tonight. Stopped at the 34-yard line.
The guy keeps going after him. He doesn't stop. Brent Russell going back, even hustling to go pick up his helmet that was pulled off his head. As the whole defensive line putting a lot of pressure on Tinsley, Minchin, all of them doing a good job flushing him out.
So now Tusculum stares, third down and a long six, and a timeout taken by Georgia Southern. 10:30 to play, first half, 14-0. Georgia Southern with a lead. We'll return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
I'm Elena, and I'm a student at Georgia Southern University, and I've got 30 seconds to tell you why you should come here. Our campus is amazing. It's like a park, and we have some of the most awesome residence halls. It's like living in an apartment. Even though we're a major university, class sizes are small. You won't have classes with 500 students. Try asking a question in one of those. Plus, the people here are so nice. You'll fit right in. If you're like me, you'll be blown away when you see this place. Check out georgiasouthern.edu today.
Southeastern Orthopedic Center is now Optum Orthopedics. With nearly 30 satellite offices, 3 Southeast Georgia hospitals, and a variety of additional physician practices, a new name was needed, Optum Orthopedics. The Eagles rely on Optum Orthopedics to get them back in the game, and you can rely on them to get you back into the game of life. Southeastern Orthopedics is now Optum Orthopedics. New name, but as always, their commitment to their patients is forefront with the focus on you. Optum Orthopedics.
Georgia Southern football presented in part by the University Store. Much more than a bookstore, from the official Nike sideline gear to the largest selection of officially licensed hats, shirts, and gifts. Visit their main campus location or anytime online at gsustore.com. Welcome back to Allen E. Paulson Stadium. 10:30 to play. Second quarter action. 14-0. Georgia Southern with the lead. Tusculum now with the football, staring at third down and 6 at their very own 34-yard line.
Carlos Cave in there at the outside linebacker with Josh Rowe there in the middle. Butler in there. Westbrook's back at safety. Hyden trying to get the student section riled up.
Bo Cordell, 12 of 16 and an interception thus far. He's had a couple of drops in this game. Cordell buying time, moving the pocket to the left. Now fires far sideline and incomplete up around the 45 and midfield. Carter and Smith, the intended receivers, take your pick, but it's incomplete. Sets up fourth down and 6 at the 34.
I'll tell you what, if there's a better covering linebacker than Darius Eubanks in the country, did you see him zigzag a man over the top? And then as soon as the ball breaks, he breaks toward the sidelines, and he just about picked that off.
I'm going to tell you another linebacker who's actually a defensive tackle there, Brent Russell. He fell back into a linebacker in coverage, did a fantastic job across the middle.
Rossetti on for the punt, kicks it away from the 25, Swope again at the 33, fields it, breaks one tackle, now breaks another, now still on his feet across the 40, coming to the near side, 45, 50, looking for someone to block for him. He's inside the Tusculum 40 before being dropped by a gang of Pioneers at the 39-yard line. Dominic Swope almost appeared to be looking for somebody to tackle him. And a great return by the freshman out of Buford, Georgia, sets up the Eagles quite nicely here.
You know what, Terry? I think he may work out back there.
I think you're right. He took the initial. It looked like it was going to be one of those boom hits. You know, right as you catch it, you get nailed. The problem is the guy didn't know he was hitting a brick wall. He hit Swoop and fell off of him. And then Swoop just starts knocking people down as he's rambling down the sideline.
They've got Dominic Swoop at 6 feet, 192 pounds. That is kind. First down and 10 at the 40 for the Eagles. Flex bone formation. A receiver, one to each side. Shaw under center. Robert Brown, your B-back. They'll motion Wilcox left to right. Shaw looking to throw. Fires across the middle. McKinnon's got it at the 20, to the 10, to the 5. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Jarek McKinnon in the slot. Comes out to catch the slam. And he's in for the score. It's 20 to nothing with 9:58 to play here in the second quarter.
Right up the middle. Beautiful. That's a classic Georgia Southern pass play. Used to see that to Frankie Johnson back in the day all the time. Good to see it back.
So McKinnon with his first receiving touchdown of the year. His third touchdown score of the season. Adrian Mora on.
I think that game tracker on that play is going to be pretty easy.
Snap, set, kick, gets on its way into the Bishop Fieldhouse, and it's good. 21 to nothing, 9:56 to play here in the first half. We'll take a timeout. We'll return in just a moment. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
103.7 The Boomer.
At B&M Pool Spa and Patio in Metter, your pool is your paradise. So treat it right by installing or upgrading to the Totally Hayward system. With the Totally Hayward system, you get the best components designed to work together for optimal performance all season long. Hayward pumps, filters, heaters, cleaners, lighting, and controls keep your pool at its best. See your Hayward Select dealer because it's totally easy to be totally Hayward. B&M Pool Spa and Patio, North Leroy Street in Metter.
Hey, this is Statesboro Auto Sales, 489-5758. We will save you your money. Compare our prices on program off-lease cars. A 2010 Ford Fusion SE, over $3,000 less than the local dealers. And we do not advertise payments. We show you the whole price of the car. We help you watch out for your money. What better car dealer friend? Us, Statesboro Auto Sales.
.58 to play here in the second quarter, and Georgia Southern now leads 21 to nothing. A great return by Dominique Swoop sets up the Eagles inside Tusculum territory. One play, Jay Shaw to Jarek McKinnon. I think took 3 seconds off the clock, and the Eagles extend their lead 21 to nothing.
Yeah, there's my Toyota game tracker. One play, 38 yards, used 4 seconds. Stand corrected thanks to another great punt return. Georgia Southern goes up 21 to nothing. They've had 16 plays so far, 174 yards. The biggest statistic that sticks out to me is they're averaging almost 11 yards every time they touch the ball. 11 yards, 10.9 per carry. So good job on the day. Punt returns. We've had 2 punt returns for 66 yards. And there's your Toyota game tracker.
Georgia Southern football powered by Georgia Power, proud supporter of the Eagles, the official power supplier to Eagle fans everywhere. Georgia Power, a Southern company. Frankie DeBusk and the Tusculum Pioneers break from the far side. Had pretty good field position at times. They've moved the ball at times. As I mentioned, Bo Cordell, 12 of 17, one interception, but he's thrown for 99 yards at a long of 34. But once they get into Eagle territory, Georgia Southern shuts them down on the defensive side. Jay Shaw on the other side of the field, 2 of 4 for 86 yards, including the hitter to Jarek McKinnon for the score. Well, Billy Greer will tee it up, at the 30-yard line. Here's the kick, right to left. Marcus Foster end of field it at the 8-yard line, near side. Up the near sideline, across the 15, across the 20, and plop down at the 25-yard line. That's where Tusculum takes over with 9:52 to play here in the second quarter of action.
Good hang time on that kickoff by Billy Greer. Good coverage. Angled it to the left side, or the home side, I should say. Did a good job pursuit. A little scoring update. Auburn knocks off Mississippi State 41-34. It's still 14-13. South Carolina over Georgia at this point. Alabama pulling away from Penn State 27-11. And Virginia Tech pulls out a victory over East Carolina 17-10. Get you some FCS scores next time.
Can't wait to get you the attendance for today. This place is filling up nicely here. First down and 10 at the 25. Cordell drops it off over the middle. It's going to be Marcus Foster. He's got some daylight up across the 30 and stopped at the 35-yard line. Zach York and Javon Minchin on the stop for the Eagles right at the first down sticks. Let's see, it is a first down for the Tusculum Pioneers, who've racked up some first downs in this game. There's no doubt about it. That'll be their sixth of the game.
Little crossing patterns there, little dumping it across.
Two receivers left, two to the right. Shuttle pass to Marcus Foster right up the gut. He gets to the 36, a gain of a yard before Brent Russell shuts that down.
Daly doing a good job as he's getting some playing time, tripping him up as well. Short and stout, 6'2", 315 pounds, Alalula, Georgia.
Second down, 9 at the 36-yard line. Tusculum attacking left to right, working from the far side hash. Cordell back in the pocket, has time, floats this one in the flat. Catch made by Foster, but dropped immediately by Josh Rowe. No gain on the play. Got back to the 36 as Cordell moved to his left, threw back to his right, and no gain on the play.
Josh Rowe showing his speed, too. Came in quickly to make that tackle. Third down coming up. The Tusculum is 2 of 7 on third down conversions today.
Third and 9 from the 36-yard line this time, near side hash. Stack receivers 2 to the right side, 2 receivers to the left. Cordell in the pocket, throws deep. Near sideline, got a man open. Catch is made by Rashad Carter deep inside Eagle territory and brought down at the 13-yard line. Beautiful throw by Bo Cordell right on the run for Rashad Carter, a senior out of Stone Mountain, Georgia. Had 8 receptions for 110 yards last week.
Wow. He just burned us, Chris. He used his speed. Presume on trying to run stride with him. Outran Hayden. And Presume played the receiver versus the ball.
So first down and 10 now at the Eagle 13-yard line. As deep as Tusculum been all evening. Swing pass, giving it off to Foster. Was it A? Did he throw it behind him? They'll say it's incomplete. Almost a lateral there as Foster got lined up after the snap. Very close as Roderick Tinsley, Hot Rod, comes up with the ball. 51-yard pass on the play before from Cordell to Carter, and the fans thought that that was thrown behind Cordell. Very close from our vantage point, but the officials immediately on the call say it was an incomplete pass. It'll set up second down and 10 from the Eagle 13.
Oh, yeah, it's just a case where he just outran us on the previous play, Chris. It was a great pass and great catch, but literally just smoked us.
Two receivers to the left, two receivers, one in a slot right side. Cordell out of a shotgun. He'll have Foster on a wing to his right. Snap back on second down and 10. Cordell throwing to the end zone, left corner, and LaRon Scott made a play on it. Ran out of room, but the only player to make a play. Intended receiver, once again, Rashad Carter, sets up third down and 10 at the 13-yard line.
And the heads up, Ryan, of LaRon Scott to turn himself into the receiver once again and try to catch it over his shoulder.
Yeah, and he floated right up underneath that thing. I thought he had it all day long, just not able to look into it.
LaRon with his back to the quarterback, as Ryan said, just couldn't look it in, and again, the sun in his eyes.
Sun's just now starting to go down. I tell you, first quarter, it was impossible looking toward Bishop Fieldhouse.
Third down and 10 at the 13. Shotgun snap, Cordell looking left. Pocket collapsing. He'll step up. Fire. Complete at the 5 to Rashad Carter. He'll dive in, and he'll get the Tusculum score. Rashad Carter gets in to make it 21-6. And credit Bo Cordell, having plenty of patience in that pocket, stepped up for 3 steps and hit Carter at the 5. He leans in, gets the ball over the plane, and the Pioneers on the board with 7:49 to play here in the second quarter.
Again, getting the pressure on the quarterback, but he's doing a good job, like you mentioned, stepping up, showing that patience. He's got a great wide receiver to throw it to.
Kick by Logan Cornelius is up, and it's good. So Tusculum on the board here. It's now 21-7 with 7:49 to play in the second quarter. We'll step away for a timeout. We'll return in just a moment. This is Georgia Southern football.
So what does a good time sound like? Does it pack a punch?
This is for the UFC light heavyweight belt. Here we go!
Or is it off the grid?
4 days, 3 nights, and absolutely no email. Ah, here we go.
A good time can sound like just about anything, but there's one sound that goes with a good time every time. Bud Light. Here we go. Please drink responsibly. Bud Light Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Yeah! Take that touchdown to the bank!
Now you can watch live college football on your Verizon phone.
Run him over. Yeah!
Get over 75 live college games.
That's how you do it.
But don't just take my word for it.
What a catch!
Take his. Only Verizon offers you an experience as big as this. Find it all at VerizonWireless.com/video. Verizon, giving you college football on the go. Subscription required. Data charges apply according to your plan. Coverage not available everywhere.
.749 to play, second quarter, 21-7. Tusculum down the field. Hits the score. Good job by Bo Cordell. And Rashad Carter, two big plays, gets them in the end zone.
Seven-play drive, Chris, started at the 25-yard line. Ate up a little bit over 2 minutes of clock there. But like you mentioned, two great pass plays. We're getting pressure on the quarterback. But Carter getting wide open, using his speed, and then coming back to him again. And they put some points on the board, and now kicking off into the sun.
Cornelius will kick it away. Line drive kick. LaRon Scott, Jarrett McKinnon back to receive. Scott will field it on the run at the 10, far side across the 20-25. Flags come out everywhere as he makes it to the 27-yard line. We'll take a timeout. Pause for station identification. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football here on the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Follow the Eagles all season on 103.7 The Boomer, WBNZ, Metro Statesboro, Swainsboro, the official flagship station of Georgia Southern Athletics.
Welcome back to the Verizon broadcast booth. Chris Blair, Terry Harvin, Brian Chambers, Russ Brown along with you this Saturday evening, 21-7. Georgia Southern leads over Tusculum. Georgia Southern on the kickoff. Called for an infraction, so what was at the 27-yard line will be backed up here on special teams for the Eagles.
Legal block in the back. They called on the Eagles. It's going to back them up to the 17-yard line.
So first down.
Worst starting position of the day, isn't it?
And 10 at the 17-yard line. Eagles huddling up near side.
Jacksonville State and Chattanooga are knotted up at 7 apiece as they wind down the first quarter of play up in Chattanooga.
First down and 10 at the 17-yard line for the Eagles. Attacking right to left. Zach Walker in as a receiver, far side. Jabo Shaw under center. Here's the pitch deep in the hole. Wilcox, far side, 20. In traffic, makes his way up to the 25-yard line. Nice pickup by Wilcox in traffic. Setting up second down and 3 here for the Eagles with 7:29 to play. Still first half action from Allen E. Paulson Stadium.
Able to seal that outside man, open it up for Wilcox. Tried to cut it back into the field of play. Gets the defense pressure there.
Lining up as a receiver near side, Mitch Williford. Walker in as the receiver, far side. Second down and 2. At the 25-yard line, Shaw gives it off, and Robert Brown trying to make his way to the 23. And now it looks like he's got it to about the 24-yard line, enough for a Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles.
Moves the chains. Move the chain, gang. I got to hang out with him, by the way, before the game.
You hang out with a lot of people.
I do. That's what I do. When you guys are working, I'm tailgating. It's the beauty of my job.
First down and 10 now at the 28. Franklin first down from Robert Brown. Checking in as a receiver near side, Contrellis Showers. Jabo Shaw under center. Late pitch again. Here's Wilcox around the right edge. 30, 35. Caught from behind and dropped at the 37-yard line.
Great block by Brett Moore. Tackle the senior out of Warner Robins, Georgia, doing a good job. Northside High School kid sealing it off for Wilcox.
Fans eat Georgia Southern first down presented by Franklin Chevrolet. If you want to move it, haul it, tow it, or just want the best deal on a great-looking truck, go to Franklin Chevrolet or FranklinChevrolet.com. If the Franklin's name is not on the back of your truck, you paid too much. Second down, two. Now at the 37-yard line, far side hash. Shaw under center, flex bone formation. They'll motion Hickey right to left. Shaw coming out firing. He's got Showers complete far sideline. Stopped at the 44-yard line. Marcus Farmer on the reception, getting into the game.
Love it when those receivers look that ball in like that.
So Coach Jeff Munkin and offensive coordinator Brent Davis starting to work in some fresh faces here with 5:42 to go. Williford now will check in as a receiver left side. First down and 10 at the 45-yard line. Shaw under center. Give it off Brown, left side. Tusculum stays at home and drops him at the line of scrimmage. No gain, no loss on the play. Dominic James on the stop for Tusculum, a freshman out of St. Petersburg, Florida. Getting the call this week is Iapala, one of their star linebackers, injured in the game against West Georgia last week. Out for 6 to 8 weeks. So James, the freshman out of St. Petersburg, getting plenty of action today. Second down, 10 from the 45 of the Eagles. Shaw again in the flex bone. Williford wide to the left side. Farmer wide out to the right side. Wilcox and Brian in as your A-backs. The carry off on the dive to Robert Brown. Makes it up to midfield. Pick up of 5 yards. It'll set up third down and 5 for the Eagles offense here with 4:36 to play.
This is 1 of 3 on third down conversions today. Haven't really had a lot of opportunity for third downs. Just shy of 8 minutes in time of possession for the Eagles today.
Third and 5 from midfield. In the shadow. Ball placed middle of the field. Bryant Wilcox, your A-backs. Robert Brown, your B-back. Shaw under center. Farmer and Barker, your wideouts. Off to Brown. Nearly lost the handle, but he gets to the 49-yard line of Tusculum. That's it. Set up third down. Fourth down, rather. And about 4 yards here for the Eagles. Under 4 minutes to play in the first half. Coming up at the half, Southern Halftime Report presented by the Georgia Lottery. Russ Brown will take you through the first half highlights, and there were plenty of it early on for Georgia Southern. As well, we'll introduce you to the new director of Southern Pride, Dr. Colin McKenzie. Southern Pride will perform here at the half, one of 4 proposed halftime shows this season at Paulson Stadium. Charlie Edwards punts it away from the 40-yard line. Fair catch called for, but over the head and in the end zone as Jonathan Bryant was down there trying to field, and Tusculum did a pretty good job of keeping him out of the play. It's in the end zone, a touchback. Pioneers start off first down at 10 at their own 20-yard line with 3:23 to go here in the first half.
Charlie did exactly what he needed to do, angled that punt, nice hang up there. Thought we had it down, but Tusculum did a fantastic job of taking our guy out of the play, literally driving him into the end zone so he couldn't kick the ball back.
So Tusculum, after putting together a 75-yard drive to get on the scoreboard, comes back out on offense, led by quarterback Bo Cordell, a junior. As I mentioned, a Harlan Hill Trophy candidate, finished fourth in the voting last year, has over 4,600 yards in his career. Actually, over 8,000 yards in his career, had 4,600 plus last year with 38 touchdowns. First down and 10. Firing out in the flat left side, Michael Rodriguez got some room across the 25 and dropped at the 27-yard line, shy of the first down. But a good pickup for the Pioneers with 3:12 to play.
Well, Ron Scott was going to make a play on that one. Even though taking a block, he almost made the tackle. Tusculum getting something going on their offense. They're up to 172 yards of offense, averaging a little over 5 yards per play.
Third down and 3 at the 27. Cordell, shotgun snap across the middle. This time out of the backfield, Brian Marshall has it across the 35 to the 37. Darius Eubanks on the stop, but it's enough for a Pioneer first down.
Eubanks delivered a vicious hit, Ryan, but a little too late.
Yeah, that's right. And they've been able to get that, and I talked about it early, is getting them off the field. Their offense can't.
Here's a shovel pass on first down and 10 off to Brian Marshall. He'll go right up the middle to the 44-yard line. Darius Eubanks again on the stop. Georgia Southern now. Riyad Jones on the field in that defensive backfield along with Michael Butler, Lavelle Westbrooks, Derek Hayden, and LaRon Scott. Harris Eubanks getting it done on the last two plays. Second down and five, though, at the 44-yard line as Tusculum keeps creeping up near midfield. Another shovel pass. This one is on the carpet and incomplete. Trying to hit Marshall at the 46-yard line. Javon Minchin diving on it.
Javon Minchin doing a great job on that play. I was about to say that shuttle pass will help offset all that pressure you're getting from the front four guys. That particular play, Minchin smelled out the shovel as we replace all four of our defensive linemen and bring some new guys in. Gephardt back into the ball game, as is Minchin and Bailey. So we're just running with a four-man front again with Douglas in there as well.
Third down and four for the Pioneers. Four of nine on third down so far today. 2:05 to play here in the second quarter. Shotgun snap, Cordell folding back. Now passes. Rodriguez has it near side, cuts up the middle of the field, across midfield, and picks up the first down at the Georgia Southern 46-yard line. Josh Rowe on the stop for the Eagles.
Picked up the first down and lost his helmet in the process. That's the third time seen a helmet fall off the kid's head today, as Zach York out of Hartwell, Georgia, checks into the ballgame at linebacker. Replaced Josh Rowe.
More substitutions coming in for Georgia Southern defensively here with 1:45 to play. First down and 10 at the 47. Screen pass far side. Deontay Gist trying to get something going and absolutely mashed by Darius Eubanks at the 45-yard line. Only a pickup of a yard and a half. And Gist will remember that hit.
Wow, Josh. Darius Eubanks can throw a hit, that's for sure.
Deion Stanley into the game in the Georgia Southern secondary here. Second down and seven. Cordell fires far side at the first down. Sticks, and Rodriguez has it out of bounds far sideline. It's a first down for Tusculum. Now they'll mark it at the 35-yard line of Georgia Southern with a minute 15 to go. And Tusculum starting to get a little confidence in that passing game, Terry.
And the coaches next door to me are sounding more and more frustrated as the walls get hit harder and harder.
1:15 to play. First half action. First down and 10 now at the Eagle 35. Cordell, pocket collapsing. He'll step up, gets away from a couple of defenders. Now fires sidearm. Catch made at the 25-yard line. Headed down the far sideline or near sideline is Deontay Gist. And he'll be all the way down to the Georgia Southern 4-yard line. And Cordell showing quite a bit of stamina there in the pocket. All kinds of duress. And just sidearms it out to Gist, and he picks up a big gainer. First down, goal to goal for the Tusculum Pioneers.
Great pressure on him. Coach Monk can give him a little bit of earful because he thinks he missed the block in the back, which may agree with him, but it was a good play by Tusculum.
Stand corrected. Gist was down at the 12, so it's first down and 10 at the 12. Not first down and goal. It's Cordell in the shotgun. Fires across the middle. This one incomplete at the goal line. Looking for Gist again. And on coverage, Deion Stanley right on top of Gist.
You know, that may only be the second or third rushed throw Cordell's made. And you made the comment, Chris, at the end of the first quarter. It looks lazy. It's just almost so smooth. It's very effortless. And he's got a lot of confidence in there. You hadn't seen him rush a whole lot of throws like he zipped that one in the end zone and missed.
Rashad Williams getting some pressure. Some new names we're calling now as they get into the ballgame.
1 minute to play here in the second quarter. 21-7 our score. Georgia Southern on top. Tusculum knocking at the door. Second down and 10 at the 12. Sidearm pass across the middle. Catch made by Brian Marshall. And Marshall inside the five of the Eagles. They'll mark him down at the 2-yard line. And that should be enough for a Tusculum first down. The sticks at the 2-yard line would set it up first down, goal to go for Tusculum with 50.5 seconds remaining here in the first half.
I tell you, this quarterback, he's a tough cookie because he just got nailed again by Brent Russell, driven into the dirt. But they're moving the chains.
So the passing game has come alive here for Tusculum. No surprise. They're going to throw it all over the field. And right now, the last drive, 75 yards for a score. And with 43 seconds to go here in the first half, looking at first down, goal to go at the two. They give it off to Marshall. He got hit behind the line and then dropped back at the 9-yard line. A loss of seven as Georgia Southern came crashing through the offensive front of Tusculum.
Big time play, the right time when we need it. We got to call a timeout. Tusculum does with 30 seconds left to go in the half. And this Tusculum team's trying to put some points on the board to make it 21-14 before going in the locker room, Ryan. But great pressure by our front four and a great job of just nailing and driving him backwards.
We've got better and better pressure, as we've talked about from the front four, and you got Darius Eubanks up there and Michael Butler, some of those guys that are so good up against the run. And I tell you something I've seen in the second quarters, Bo Cordell has had and shown more of a desire to get out of the box, out of the pocket, and start running. He's actually a lot more mobile than I thought. The first couple of drives, he looked like he just had no desire to really move laterally, and he's really creating himself some time. We talked about depth. Third, fourth quarter, we'll see how this offensive line holds up against Georgia Southern. Maybe deepest position is there at that defensive interior line up front, and so you're seeing some of that start to evaporate a little bit. The blocking up front, and Cordell's going to have to move the rest of this ball game if he wants to keep plays alive.
Yeah, Chris, to Ryan's point there, we've already seen Bailey into the ball game. 6'2", 315-pound deep. We've seen Rashad Williams in the game. We've seen several names that we haven't called out a lot until now. So these fresh legs are going to be or pay off dividends, hopefully, in the second half.
Second down, 10. Ball placed at the 10-yard line. It's second down, goal to goal for the Pioneers. Down 21-7. Trip receivers left, one to the right side. Cordell setting up in the flat. Catch by Foster. He goes untouched into the end zone. It's a 21-13 game with 26.4 seconds remaining. Tusculum not going away.
They're doing a great job of sucking us in, and that's exactly what they did. They smelled the blitz coming. Hyden come in on a blitz, Ryan. He was wide open there in the flats.
No, they've done that. They've almost guessed exactly right on our blitzes off the corner. You've seen them zip them beside Darius Eubanks coming up the middle, and that time the same thing right off the right end.
Logan Cornelius on for the point after, trying to make it a one-score game. Kick is up, nearly blocked, but he gets it up and good. 21-14 with 26.4 seconds remaining. So Tusculum, the Division II team out of Greenville, Tennessee, not going away lightly here. We'll take a timeout, return for the finish of the first half in just a moment. Georgia Southern 21, Tusculum 14. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Bales Transmission and Service in Statesboro does more than repair transmissions. They're now a full-service auto mechanic shop with easy financing and towing available. Student and commercial discounts, too. Bales Transmission and Service, Cypress Lake Road on the bypass just up from 301 South, Statesboro.
For great deals, shop the Statesboro Flea Market off the north end of the bypass at 158 East Parish. Household items, new and used clothing, arts and crafts, antiques and collectibles, and much, much more. Browse the vendors' booths and stop by the Horsing Around Cafe or the Hair Salon, and they consign your merchandise. Don't miss the truckload sale on new outdoor furniture and patio accessories on now at Statesboro Flea Market. Call 912-536-6917. Proud supporters of GSU football.
David Emanuel Academy in Stillmore makes the choice of where to send your child to school so easy. For information and a visit to David Emanuel Academy, just call or stop by. They'll give you all the choices DEA has to offer to give your child the education he or she deserves. David Emanuel Academy in Stillmore, home of the Eagles.
What was once 21-0 is now 21-14 here at Alan E. Paulson Stadium. 26.4 seconds remain here in the first half. Tusculum kicking off to Georgia Southern. And two back-to-back well-executed drives by the Pioneers, Terry.
12 plays, 80 yards, 2 minutes and 57 seconds as Tusculum kicks off. And I was expecting Ryan's favorite kickoff, the squib, but they didn't.
Ron Scott fields it at the 5 far side. Now he'll come across a lot of real estate up across the 25. He's got room 40. He's across midfield at the 50 and eventually driven out of bounds at the 39-yard line by the Pioneers. Ron Scott last week a 99-yard touchdown return. Very close. You could almost sense the crowd here at Paulson holding their breath as Ron Scott made the decision after fielding it far side. Saw the seam to the near side and picks up great field position. Just 17.1 seconds remain here in the first half. A 21-14 game. And Georgia Southern's offense now will huddle up near side and got to take away this momentum. That certainly, if you can do it with a score late here in the second quarter, you take a little bit away from Tusculum.
That's where they should have squibbed it. And that gives us a shot to put some points on the board before half.
First down and 10. They'll mark it at the 40-yard line of the Pioneers. Shaw out of that split gun formation. McKinnon and Brown in the backfield as Shaw has time. Now, nobody open. He'll tuck and run, and Tusculum brings him down at the 41-yard line. Luke Harris with the stop. 10 seconds remain and a timeout taken by Georgia Southern. to conserve the clock here. And good coverage downfield by the Pioneers.
As safety's playing deep quarters, they weren't letting anything get behind them, and just nothing came open in the flats. It looked like Jabo was going to try to tuck and go up here to the near side, and the last defender caught him by the shoelaces.
Yeah, I think he right when he tucked it up was when Jonathan Bryan was able to break away, getting wide open on the far sideline, standing around the 10. But by that point, Shaw had already made up his mind to bring the ball down. Good coverage by Tusculum here, and we have to burn a timeout with just 10 seconds to go. And you go twofold here. Do you try to throw something to the sideline to get you in field goal position to put 3 points on the board and stop the clock? Or do you go for it all?
I'll let you know after they do it.
Yeah, I thought you might say that.
And Terry, I got you on the kickoff, and you get a chance to see this the highlights before anybody. I want you to check out Carlos Cave on the kick return from... He de-cleats somebody over here at the 35 in one of the best blocks I've seen in 5 years down here. A huge hit that really sprung that thing from the 30.
Well, if you could see my notes, great blocking, dash Carlos Cave. So
10 seconds to play. Second quarter, second down and 11 at the Tusculum 41. Shaw now back under center. Robert Brown, your B-back. Shaw looking to throw, steps up in the pocket, and the pass deflected at the line and incomplete with 5.9 seconds. So it'll be third down and 10. The Eagles will get another shot at it here as Jabo heads over to Coach Jeff Munkin near sideline with just one play remaining in the chamber here with 5.9 seconds. The Georgia Southern Eagles got off to a good start. Jabo Shaw with 10:16 to play in the first quarter had a 25-yard touchdown run to go up 7-0. J.J. Wilcox again at 5:26 to go in the first, a 13-yard run to make it 14-0, and Georgia Southern make it 21 on Jarek McKinnon's 30-yard touchdown pass. So the final play of the first half, barring a penalty. Third and 11, Shaw firing in the flat, far side, caught at the 20 by J.J. Wilcox, but he'll be dropped at the 19 with 0.1 second. The clock has not gone zero, and they'll call a timeout. So look for Adrian Mora to trot onto the field to try to add to this lead, 21-14. As I mentioned, Georgia Southern up 21-0. Then here come the Tusculum Pioneers. Rashad Carter, a 13-yard touchdown pass from Bo Cardell to make it 21-7 with 7:49 to go in the second quarter. And then Marcus Foster on a 10-yard pass from Cordell made it 21-14. So it's been a tale of the first half for Georgia Southern offensively. And it's been a lot of Tusculum here in the second quarter to make it a 21-14 game. The Eagles looking at first down and 10 on the Franklin first down reception by J.J. Wilcox at the 20-yard line. They'll bring in Adrian Mora with 0.1 seconds remaining here on the clock at Allen E. Paulson Stadium to try to extend this lead to 10 going into the halftime locker room. Adrian Mora on the year had one field goal, 41 yards. His long is 50 yards against Wofford in his career back in 2009. So timeout on the field. Tusculum coming away from the far side huddle. Now the Eagles breaking as Adrian Mora and Charlie Edwards will set up and tee this thing up here.
And they're not Tusculum coaches aren't happy about the clock management either.
36-yard field goal attempt right down the middle of the field, just off the far side hash. With 0.1 seconds remaining. Carter Jones will do the snapping. Charlie Edwards will do the hold. Here it goes. Kick is up. Plenty of leg. Kick is on its way. Kick is good. Adrian Mora puts a boost in the arm for the Georgia Southern Eagles, who head to the locker room now at the end of the first half, up 24-14 over the Tusculum Pioneers. Let's go down on the field, catching up with head coach Jeff Munkin, Ryan Chambers.
I think he's trying to catch coach now.
Coach is on his way to talk to, I think, the officiating crew.
But a great pass to set that up from Jabo Shaw, firing that in to Wilcox. We've seen Wilcox do that, Chris, time and time again and bring down those big-time catches, and he came up big again. And again, Coach Munkin having a word with the officials right now, which is why Ryan Chambers is not able to visit with him. And I think he wants a clarification from the official on that blocking below the knee. And, you know, that interpretation, because that's the exact official he was talking to earlier, Ryan. And Coach Munkin's still not happy with the answer he's getting.
So Coach Munkin still pleading his case, and now he'll make it over, and we'll get the halftime thoughts of Eagle head coach Jeff Munkin.
Coach, I know you want seven, but you get three. It won't go away. What's the thought is going into the half?
Well, we got to can't get three and out, and we can't punt the ball, can't give up big plays. That's the bottom line.
How big is it to get a score early in this ball game against what's probably going to be one of the biggest crowds in this stadium's had in the last 5 years?
Oh, the crowd's great, and I hope we can give them a better performance in the second half.
Good luck in the second half, Coach. Thanks. Guys.
Thank you, Coach. Thank you, Ryan. We're at halftime here at the prettiest little stadium in America, about to be entertained by the hardest working band in show business, Southern Pride. Coming up, it's the Southern Halftime Report, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Russ Brown will be in the chair here at the Verizon broadcast booth, take you through the first half highlights, update you on scores from around the Southern Conference, around FCS, and the top 25 in the FBS as we continue from Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Your score at the break, Georgia Southern leads by 10 over Tusculum, 24-14. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football.
Okay, it's game day, where tradition runs deeper than your Aunt Betty's baked beans. Face paint? Check. Cooler? Check. Meat for the grill? Check. Ford F-150 with best-in-class towing, payload, and a V6 EcoBoost engine delivering 22 mpgs. Check, check, and check. Now check this. Go to shopfordnow.com to find great offers on F-150 from your local Ford dealer. Fans of Georgia Southern football. EPA estimated 16 city, 22 highway mpg, 3.5 liter V6, 4x2.
I'm Jeff Munkin, head football coach at Georgia Southern University. My job is to prepare players to win football games and succeed in life. To do this, I know it's essential for the Eagles to perform together with outstanding effort in order to ensure success. When I was shopping for a bank, my philosophy was just as simple. My direction and excellent team delivery. Take it from the coach. The Citizens Bank team wins. For simple banking your way, stop by and see Kevin Harrison and the staff at Citizens Bank of Bullitt County, equal housing lender and member FDIC.
Going to a high school or GSU football game this weekend? Be sure to save your ticket stub. Bring it to the pizza box anytime the following week and receive a $2 discount off any large pizza. You heard right. Your ticket stub from any GSU or area high school football game is worth $2 off any large pizza the next week at the pizza box. So support your favorite team. Save the ticket stub and get $2 off any large pizza. Only at the Pizza Box, next to Queensboro Bank in Metter.
James Penley, owner of Southern Pawn and Gold in Swainsboro, buys, sells, and trades just about anything. Jewelry, appliances, guns, tools, electronics, musical, and car stereo equipment. Cricket buys your gold at the best prices around. Cash your checks there, pay your bills. Car stereo installation, too. Southern Pawn and Gold, South Main, Swainsboro.
Michael Bright invites you into his new store with a new name, Swainsboro Antiques and Unique Collectibles. Now open right downtown Swainsboro on the square. See a beautiful line of antique items plus genuine articles actually owned by Elvis Presley. Swainsboro Antiques and Unique Collectibles, new name, new location, downtown Swainsboro.
At Sea Island Bank, we're passionate about Metter and Candler County. Whether it's our local schools and athletic programs, chamber events, or the Bloomin' Festival, you'll find our team members lending a helping hand. And if you need a financial partner, Billy Patterson and his staff are ready with local decisions, sound advice, and friendly service. Come see us today or visit us online at seaislandbank.com. We're passionate about our customers and the community we serve. Sea Island Bank, a division of Synovus Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
I know 0.0 about technology, but I did get a programmable thermostat. You know, you can make it so the air's not running while you're gone, and when you get home, the house is still a perfect temperature. It feels really good when I'm paying the electric bill. I'm saving $280 a year just by pushing a few buttons. What can you do? Find out how the little changes add up at togetherwesave.com.
Canucci EMC, a Touched Home Energy Cooperative in Reidsville.
You're listening to the flagship station of GSU Athletics, 103.7 The Boomer.
Welcome into the Southern Halftime Report, presented by the Georgia Lottery on the Georgia Southern Radio Network. The Georgia Lottery. Remember, today could be the day. And now, from the Verizon broadcast booth, here is Russ Brown.
Russ Brown and Terry Harvin here from the Verizon broadcast booth. Your score at the half, Georgia Southern leads the Tusculum Pioneers by a score of 24-14. And Terry, Georgia Southern jumped out to an early 21-0 lead, but Tusculum with a nice second quarter there. They put a couple of touchdowns on the board to cut the lead 21-14, and then the Eagles able to answer with a field goal right there before the half. Your score 24-14.
Yeah, it was a tale of two quarters, I should say. Give credit where credit's due. Tusculum coaching staff did a good job of making adjustments both offensively and defensively. But let's take a look at some stats. Toyota Game Tracker stats. Tusculum at 252 yards, first half yards on 46 plays, averaging 5.5 yards per play. They punted four times, 34.5 yards in your punting in time of possession, 17-38. Third down conversions, 5 of 10. The leading rusher, just 8 yards. For Tusculum, I take that back. The quarterback has 12 yards. Their leading receiver has 75 yards. Another receiver has 50. Another has 77. Another has 39. I think you get the picture of where their yardage is coming from. Georgia Southern, 228 yards of total offense, averaging 8.8 yards per carry or per possession. Three punts, 45.7 yards per punt. 2 of 5 on third down conversions. Leading receiver for the Eagles is J.J. Wilcox. 5 catches for Leading rusher is J.J. Wilcox. 5 rushes for 55 yards and 1 touchdown. Jabo Shaw, 7 rushes for 28 yards and 1 touchdown. Robert Brown, 6 carries for 26 yards. Showers, 1 catch for 48 yards. McKinnon, 1 for 38. Wilcox, 1 for 20. And that 1 for 20, Russell, was a big one because it enabled our Mr. Automatic Mora to come in and put 3 points on the board with .01 ticks on the clock before half.
And that possession, of course, set up by another great kick return by LaRon Scott to get Georgia Southern the field position it needed to get that field goal. Terry, just a few minutes here before we go to break, but put yourself in the shoes of the coaching staff right now. For the Eagles, you're up 24-14. You got off to a good start, maybe a little sluggish there in the second quarter. What's your message to the team at halftime?
Oh, guys, you can't get complacent. Now, you go up 21-0, and I think started feeling a little bit confident about themselves. They certainly, I'm not saying they weren't playing hard, but those little dink and dunk passes were there. Our guards are dropping out. We got to do a better job in pursuit, better job of wrapping up here in the second half, and do what we do best, but we've got to open up the middle. Robert Brown, having 26 yards here at half, tells us that the middle is not open. We've got to do a better job of making a lane open for Robert Brown.
And we'll see what that coaching staff does in the second half to do that. Partner, have a great second half call. We'll catch up with you then. This is the Southern Halftime Report presented by the Georgia Lottery. Play Jeep Outdoor Adventure Sweepstakes today. The Georgia Lottery today could be the day. Again, your score at the half, Georgia Southern leads Tusculum 24-14. Back with more of the Southern Halftime Report right after this.
103.7 The Boomer.
Chris Stanford at Stanford's Quality Collision Center in Twin City offers professional quality auto body repair at affordable prices. When you have an accident, large or small, get an estimate from Stanford's. They also do expert custom design painting. They'll make your vehicle look brand new. Check them out. Stanford's Quality Collision Center, Twin City.
Sykes Brothers Incorporated, Metter, Vidalia, and Statesboro are ready to give you info on extending the life of your asphalt drives, parking areas, even streets. Call 685-6328. Grading, land clearing, excavating, and more. Sykes Brothers, Metter, Statesboro, and Vidalia.
At B&M Pool Spa and Patio in Metter, your pool is your paradise. So treat it right by installing or upgrading to the Totally Hayward system. With the Totally Hayward system, you get the best components designed to work together for optimal performance all season long. Hayward pumps, filters, heaters, cleaners, lighting, and controls keep your pool at its best. See your Hayward Select dealer because it's totally easy to be totally Hayward. B&M Pool Spa and Patio, North Leroy Street, in Metter.
Don Flanders at Handy House Manufacturing in Swainsboro has the answer to all your storage needs. Stop by and see their big selection of all-size storage buildings. Make a purchase or use their easy-to-rent-own program. Handy House Manufacturing, South Main, Swainsboro. They'll cover what you want to keep safe.
The Movie Store in Metter is open 7 days weekly with all the latest DVD and Blu-ray movies and a huge selection of video games. And with the new supplier, their movie selection is even greater. And the newest arrivals are 28 days ahead of the other guys. The Movie Store, North Lewis Street in Metter.
Jimmy Davis at Davis Automotive and Tires in Brooklyn is ready to help with all your auto repair needs and new tires. For expert automotive work and prices that won't bust your wallet, see Jimmy Davis. From oil changes to motor changeouts to tires to fit most anything, it's Davis Automotive and Tires in Brooklyn.
The home of the Georgia Southern Eagles. The official flagship station for GSU Athletics. 103.7 The Boomer.
Welcome back to the Southern Halftime Report, presented by the Georgia Lottery on the Georgia Southern Radio Network. The Georgia Lottery. Remember, today could be the day.
Russ Brown back with you in the Verizon Wireless broadcast booth. Let's get a quick look at the first half scoring summary. Tusculum took the opening kickoff before punting, and then on its first possession, Georgia Southern goes four plays, 40 yards, capped off on a 25-yard touchdown run by Jabo Shaw. Adrian Mora added the extra point, and the score stood there at 7-0. Again, the Pioneers forced a punt. Georgia Southern on their second possession. They go four plays, 80 yards. J.J. Wilcox, a 13-yard touchdown run to cap it off. Moore's extra point was good. The score then 14-0. Then the Eagle defense forces an interception. Georgia Southern forced a punt.
Effective here today, first down and 10 at the 43. Another sidearm pass, far side. Deontay Gist trying to come back on the screen. He got back to the line of scrimmage after curling back to the middle of the field. Brent Russell laid him down there, and it'll set up second down and 10 from the 43-yard line of the Pioneers.
Yeah, you're going to cut back into the defense. The guy you don't want to run into is big number 66.
I mentioned before the game, guys, again in the win over Western Carolina, how good they were when it counted 5 of 6 in that second quarter to open up that big lead. I think the third down is really the key, getting off the field and getting them off the field, their offense off the field.
Second down, 10 at the 43. Cordell, little lazy pump fake now. Can't throw. Moves back to his left. Now he'll try the right side again near the far sideline. Throw this one. And it is.
Had the ball skip off the padding. That it seems so simple, but he fell on it rather than pick it up, scoop it, and go. And that's just something you got to learn. Something you got to learn after things like that happen. You see that enough.
Well, the problem is it happened twice, and the second time around as well. That's our third fumble on the day. That's the first one we've lost.
4:26 to play, and Tusculum back in business. First down and 10 now inside the red zone of the Eagles at the 19. Handoff and the shotgun snap. Fred Jones will go right up the gut, make it down to the 15-yard line. Carlos Cave coming over to make the tackle. Red zone scores for Tusculum last week. 67% of the time they get a score. 33% of the time it was a touchdown against West Georgia. Last year, 91% red zone scoring for the Pioneers. Shotgun snap. Cordell flushed out, throws this one. Right corner of the end zone looking for Rashad Carter as LaRon Scott right there with him. It's incomplete. Sets up third down and 5 at the 14-yard line. Checking the scoreboard. Georgia trailing South Carolina in a shootout in Athens. 45-42. Gamecocks holding on to a 3-point lead with 2:15 to play in the fourth quarter. .358 to play third quarter, 45-21, Georgia Southern with a lead, but Tusculum, third and 5 at the Eagle 14. Shotgun snap, Cordell trots back, fires across the middle, catch is made, scooped up, flag comes out as the catch made at the 20 by Carter. He'll make his way to the near sideline and out of bounds, but it looks like this one will go against the Pioneers. That flag came out quickly at the catch.
Certainly did. I think that's going to be holding as we had one of our defensive backs coming in there on the blitz as well. Like they might have got a piece of them. Let's see which way. Yep, holding call against Tusculum. So we said there was a lack of holding, and apparently as the game has progressed, people have gotten a little tired and decided to start holding. That's going to be their 7th penalty on the day. By the way, Furman 16, the Citadel 6 with 2:58 left to go in that ball game.
Only conference game matchup of the week down at Johnson Haygood Stadium.
It's a final. South Carolina 45, Georgia 42. I hate to tell you betting people, but it covered the spread. No, it didn't.
Holding against Tusculum is the call. That'll back them up. Boy, I can feel the heat coming out of Athens right now.
Oh, boy. Batting down the hatches.
3:50 to play, third quarter, 45-21.
They scored 22 points, Georgia did, in the fourth quarter.
Another flag coming out here late.
Wow, unsportsmanlike conduct called against Tusculum here.
They have, I don't want to get too far into this, guys. You know how I am down here, but they've been a little chatty as Tusculum, and a couple of them have found the favor of the student section very early in this ball game.
And I believe I know which one did, because
it's pretty obvious.
Yeah, coach just yanked him out of the ball game to have a little words with him.
Dustin Moorhead gets a one-on-one with Coach Frankie DeBus, the senior out of Lincoln County High School of Alona, Tennessee. And I'm sure Coach DeBus not thrilled that after they worked inside the red zone after the fumble, now they see themselves backed up a mile with the ball placed down at the Eagle 39-yard line, looking at third down and a cab ride of 30 yards. with 3:40 clock moving. Cordell sends out trip receivers to the right. One lone receiver left side. Shotgun snap. Here comes the screen. It'll be Carter. Carter flips it back on the hook and lateral to Marcus Foster, and he'll get some extra yards on that far sideline to the 31-yard line of Georgia Southern. Still a heap of yards to pick up for a first down, but DeBus trying to get it back on one play with 3:29 here in the third quarter.
It's a good-looking play.
So Georgia Southern's defense, Hot Rod Tinsley, trying to get the crowd on their feet here on 4th and 22. As the Tusculum offense will stay out on the field with nothing to lose. Down 45-21 here in the second half. Cordell looks to be a little confused, looking over to Coach DeBus. Now he'll shout instructions to the offensive line. Play clock down to 3. Play clock down to 2. He'll get the snap off out of the shotgun. And wait a minute. Whistles blow, and I believe a timeout taken by Tusculum. Indeed, it was. 3:07 to play. The Pioneers not put together, and a timeout taken. 45-21, Georgia Southern with the lead. 4th and 22, and the Pioneers are going for it. When we return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium, this is Georgia Southern football.
Bales Transmission and Service in Statesboro does more than repair transmissions. They're now a full-service auto mechanic shop with easy financing and towing available. Student and commercial discounts, too. Bales Transmission and Service, Cypress Lake Road on the bypass just up from 301 South, Statesboro.
Stateview Mini Storage Manor and in Twin City, Behind the Time Saver offers climate control, fenced-in, lighted, camera-monitored storage buildings. Also, Wayne Supply Twin City specializes in newer replacement of windows and doors. Call John Wetzel, 478-763-2319.
Sandy Jones and Bethany Woods at Creative Cuts of Brooklyn invite you in to get that special cutter style for those special fall events and get-togethers ahead. Foil colors and perms and great haircuts for every member of the family. Call 842-2960 or walk-ins welcome. Creative Cuts of Brooklyn, Highway 80 East.
Sykes Brothers Incorporated, Mater, Vidalia, and Statesboro are ready to give you info on extending the life of your asphalt drives, parking areas, even streets. Call 685-6328. Grading, land clearing, excavating, and more. Sykes Brothers, Mater, Statesboro, and Vidalia.
Seven to play, third quarter, 4th and 22. The Tusculum offense on the field. Bo Cordell with two receivers right, two to the wide side, left side. As Cordell moves the pocket, right side throws this one. Going to be short, but it's incomplete. Far sideline looking for Deontay Gist. And for back-to-back possessions, turnover on downs gives it back to Georgia Southern with 3:02 to go here in the third quarter of action. Fans, each Georgia Southern first down presented by Franklin Chevrolet. If you want to move it, haul it, tow it, or just want the best deal on a great-looking truck, go to Franklin Chevrolet or franklinchevrolet.com. If the Franklin name's not on the back of your truck, you paid too much.
Good pressure by our defense, a good coverage by the defensive backs. He's 32 of 48 on the day as Cordell. 310 yards, thrown one interception, two touchdowns. He's got a long of 51 as McKinnon checks back into the ballgame to lead the Eagles on offense.
First down, 10 at the 31. Split gun, inverted wishbone here as McKinnon waits on the shotgun snap. He'll get it. Give it off to Swope. Swope will go right up the middle. Make his way to the 33, almost the 34-yard line. A pickup of 3. It'll set up second down and 7. Georgia Southern got off to a quick start in tonight's game. Jumped up early on Tusculum. J-Bo Shaw back in the first quarter made it 7-0 on a 25-yard run. J.J. Wilcox added a 13-yard run to make it 14-0. Then Jarek McKinnon on a 38-yard pass from Shaw made it 21-0 before Tusculum came roaring back in that second quarter. Second down, 8 at the 33. Again, inverted wishbone, and now we got whistles and a stop in action at the snap. May have had movement by Georgia Southern. Rashad Carter took a 13-yard pass from Cordell to make it 21-7 with 7:49 to go in the second quarter. And then with just 26 seconds remaining, Marcus Foster got in from 10 yards out on a pass from Cordell to make it 21-14 at the half. Or rather, Adrian Mora, I think I should say, came in with a 37-yard field goal. False start against Georgia Southern will back them up to make it 24-14 at the half. Georgia Southern came out roaring. Jonathan Bryant, an 11-yard run. Make it 31-14. Robert Brown would answer back with 8:08 to go in the third quarter. A 12-yard run to make it 38-14. Then a miscue on special teams, an onside kick attempt. And Tusculum ran it back for 38 yards to make it 38-21 before McKinnon with a 2-yard run out of the Wildcat gave us our score 45-21. Second and 13 at the 29. Again, split gun. This time off to Swope. Swope breaks off a defender at the 40. Swope takes two Pioneers down to the Tusculum 35-yard line. Franklin first down for Dominique Swope. And did he lean at all, gentlemen? He was straight up knocking people over.
He runs with speed and runs with a whole lot of strength, Ryan.
You said 192, the official number on the poundage on him.
That's the tell of the tape.
He must have taken that a hair shy of senior graduation.
But put it this way, the freshman 15 came real early for him when he got here.
2:04 to play, third quarter clock moving. First down and 10 now at the Tusculum 36-yard line. Again, inverted wishbone out of the split gun. Receiver to each side. McKinnon will keep it after pulling it out of the belly of Swope. Go around the right side and get to about the 29-yard line. Swope, 36-yard run to pick up that Franklin first down. Good pickup by McKinnon on first down from the 36. Sets him up right at the Tusculum 30-yard line.
You bunch so much personnel, it almost seems like it gives the defense one more thing to have to worry about in that inverted bone, like some kind of quick toss to either side, really.
Inverted bone again, second down, four, the Tusculum 30-yard line, a receiver to each side. High snap, but fielded by McKinnon. He'll take it out. Now he'll keep it around the right edge on his own and make it down to the 20-yard line. A good pickup of about 6 yards. It's enough for another Franklin first down for the Georgia Southern Eagles with 1:13 to go here in the third quarter. Eagles up 45-21. Ryan's exactly right, Terry. Right now, I think Tusculum having all kinds of problem knowing where that ball is going. So many options coming out of that inverted wishbone, out of the shotgun set.
It's a good look. Got a lot of fresh legs in there. Offensive line, fresh legs. B.A. everywhere.
Receiver, one to each side. First down and 10 at the 20-yard line. Inverted wishbone. This time, Robert Brown will get the carry. Try to go up the left side. B gap. Spun around and dropped at about the 17-yard line, a pickup of three.
You know, the game's always evolving, and there's somebody's going to come up with something to stop everything you do. We saw what I've called the dog defense. A lot of the coaches call that dog defense, which is the defense, three down linemen, two walking up linebackers on the end. It almost looks like a mirror image of the option. This, I think, really helps define that nose tackle, and it makes it a little bit harder having two options of that B-back to right and left of the quarterback in the shotgun.
They'll say second down and a short eight. Just inside the 18-yard line, we had movement up front before the snap.
That's the second time that's been called in our defense, in our offensive backfield leaning. We probably should have had it called three times. And Coach Munkin not happy about it, and he's already looking for somebody else to go in there.
And you see it before the snap, pre-snap, you saw the nose tackle have to slide over. Now, all of a sudden, they got to make a guessing game, whereas it's almost read and react in the normal triple option set. This gives them one more thing pre-snap to look at. And for the quarterback, when you're McKinnon, anything you can get pre-snap from the defense is sure to help, especially when you're running an option offense.
Brandavius Mann will check back in as the center. Mondre St. Amour checked out. Second down, 13. Ball placed at the 23-yard line of Tusculum. This time just split back. Formation. Throwing into the flat, high pass. Brown goes up to bring it down, but he's hit immediately by a team of Pioneers at the 25-yard line. So he's loss on the play as that one just floated a little too high out of the hand of McKinnon. That'll be the final play of the third quarter. So at the end of three, Georgia Southern leads 45-21 over the Pioneers of Tusculum. The fourth and final quarter coming your way as we return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
There's nothing like going to Georgia Southern football games dressed with the latest styles from the university store.
From Eagle jerseys, official Nike sideline gear, and largest selection of licensed caps and t-shirts, no one beats the university store.
No game day experience is quite complete without a visit to our main campus location with free parking and bus transportation to and from Paulson Stadium.
You can even shop inside at the stadium newly remodeled stadium shop.
And no matter where you are, you can share your Eagle pride by shopping online anytime at gsustore.com.
The university store, much more than a bookstore, your one-stop shop for all things Southern.
Oh, man, what a hike.
Yeah.
Whoa, Big Bear, right next to your new Jeep.
No!
Oh, I just won that from the Georgia Lottery.
Shoot.
Now he's in your Jeep.
It's on his paws. Are those driving gloves?
Mike, you left the keys under the seat.
Win one of 15 Jeep Wranglers plus $25,000 cash to make it your own. Play the new Jeep Outdoor Adventure Instant Game, only from the Georgia Lottery.
Start of the fourth quarter here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium, 45-21. Georgia Southern leading over the Tusculum Pioneers in a matchup of Division I FCS and Division II NCAA football. Next week, the Eagles are off. They'll have the off week before getting set and coming back here to Allen E. Paulson Stadium 2 weeks from tonight to take on, I believe, Western Carolina.
To give you a quick scoring update, the final in Charleston, Furman knocks off the Bulldogs 16-6. Here's a score you might be interested in. Chattanooga leading Jacksonville State 31-17.
That game's becoming an annual event for those guys. I mean, it's pretty close, I know.
Yeah,
That's a good out of conference 1AA matchup every year. It's getting better the better Chattanooga's got.
I was about to say, Chattanooga just continues to improve.
Third down and 15 as we start the fourth quarter at the 25-yard line of Tusculum. McKinnon in at quarterback, shotgun snap. Here's the pitch. It's off the mark, trying to hit Robert Brown. Threw it behind him. A late hit after Brown went down to cover up the football. The Pioneers got a little too aggressive, and they're going to pick up the personal foul, as the coaching staff for the Pioneers can't believe what they just saw.
Well, I think the Coach DeBusk and his staff are a little confused that this is college football rather than the NFL. That's a clear rule. I mean, he's down. There's no reason to tackle him.
McKinnon trying to leave Brown just a little too much. Brown doing the wise thing. Instead of trying to scoop it like we talked about earlier in the game, he fell on it. And as he hits the ground and comes to come back up, he gets tattooed by a Tusculum player, and the coach is not too happy about it.
Well, what would have been fourth and long will now, after the personal foul call, set the Eagles up with another Franklin first down and set them deeper inside Pioneer territory here with 14:51 remaining in the game. And the Eagles up 45-21. Wholesale changes offensively for Georgia Southern. As we mentioned, McKinnon now in the starting quarterback role. He'll line up in a split gun. He'll have Dominique Swope, the freshman, to his left. J.J. Wilcox, the junior, to his right. One receiver wide side of the field and one short side on the right far sideline. Now motion Sumner, the tight end. Now they'll roll to their left. McKinnon, deciding to keep, runs into a wall of Pioneers as he makes his way down inside the 10 to about the 7-yard line. Pickup of 6. It'll set up second down and 4. Maybe he got stopped. Maybe his knee slung down. They'll mark him.
That's the ninth penalty on the night for Tusculum, 85 yards in penalties.
It'll be interesting to me to see how creative they continue to get out of this set. We didn't see a lot of it last week, and then the first drive, it was all really the same play to the short side. We're starting to see a little more creativity now.
Second down, 5 at the 8 of the Pioneers. Shotgun snap off to Swope. He leapfrogs a couple of Pioneers, makes his way in from the 2 to the 1. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Dominique Swope, first career touchdown, as the Georgia Southern Eagle makes it 51-21 with 14 minutes to play. And boy, does he look impressive running the football.
I'm enjoying seeing these young Eagles develop into stars for Georgia Southern. Swope being one, McKinnon being another.
So Adrian Mora on for the point after. You got to believe many fans here, over 21,000, and those listening across the Georgia Southern Radio Network, not going to be pleased with play from start to finish in this game. But right now, things getting out of hand for Coach Frankie DeBusk and the shorthanded Tusculum Pioneers, as Morris' point after is good. Make it 52-21. Georgia Southern football powered by Georgia Power, proud supporter of the Eagles, the official power supplier to Eagle fans everywhere. Georgia Power, a Southern company. Dominique Swope, as we mentioned, freshman, 6 feet, 192-pounder, they say, out of Buford, Georgia. Had 3 carries last week for 7 yards. Comes in tonight, 4 carries, 53 yards, and his first career touchdown as an Eagle to lift Georgia Southern up 52-21 here in the fourth quarter of action.
Well, he's taking advantage of Tom Milton's weight room and Landrum Hall. Landrum Hall still here, isn't it? Serving great food. Hey, that was a 9-play drive, 69 yards, ate up 4 minutes of the clock. I believe that's our longest drive of the night, time-wise. And McKinnon leading the offense down the field. Swoop, seeing him at the running back position, doing a good job as well. Put an Eagle 6 on it.
You know, listening to a lot of the old-timers like yourself, Terry, talk about the great days.
Who you calling old?
You, back in the day of 52-21 and watching folks leave in the fourth quarter. I tell you what, you like competitive ball games, you like entertainment, you like a good football game, but dadgummit, you like 52-21 and put this thing out of hand as the clock hits 15 in the fourth.
I'll take it every time.
There's going to be a great tailgating tonight. As there was before the game, too.
Well, you met with so many people down there.
Man, I made my rounds, and speaking of that, happy birthday wishes tomorrow to Tracy James. She's one of the folks of the Move the Chain gang. Hang out in the tailgating area by the Red Flag gang, but happy birthday, Tracy, tomorrow.
So with 14 minutes to go in this game, 52-21, Georgia Southern with the lead. They'll have Gist and Foster back deep. Billy Greer will approach the ball at the 30, lifted in the air. Gist fields under it at the 11-yard line near side, up the middle of the field. Hit bounces off the defender and makes his way to the 25-yard line. Tusculum takes over first down and 10 at their own 25-yard line with 13:54 to play here in the fourth quarter of action. As I mentioned, Georgia Southern off this coming week. Be back in action on the 24th against Western Carolina, the second conference game of the season. Terry already told you that Furman picked up their first conference win, winning over the Citadel today in Charleston. Paladins now off to a 1-1 start, and with the Eagles now 1-0 in conference play.
A lot of hard hitting going on. That's the fifth helmet knocked off tonight.
Handoff on first down to Foster, trying to skirt around the left edge up across the 30, stopped at the 31-yard line.
Running their version of the inverted shotgun bone. Same formation.
Pickup of 7 yards on the carry by Foster. Make it second down and 3. They'll come back near side on the run. This time Brian Marshall making his way just shy, or got to the 35. Carlos Cave brings him down. But he got a yard and a half beyond the line. Needed for a first down, so a fresh set of downs for the Pioneers.
What I like what Carlos did is he took the blocker on, shed the blocker, and was able to trip him up.
Quick snap, handoff to Foster again, running downhill out of that shotgun. About the 38-yard line, pickup of 3, second down and 7 upcoming for Tusculum, who's trying to make haste here in this fourth quarter of action. Javon mentioned in defensively for the stop, and again, Georgia Southern substituting between plays here, trying to keep up with Tusculum, getting personnel in and off the field. First down and 10, Cordell trying to roll out to his right, throws the pass to Marshall at the 40, and it's incomplete. Marshall couldn't hold on. Set up second down and 10 from the 35-yard line. Third down and 10, rather. Third down and 5, I should say. Third down and 7. I'll get it right in a minute.
We still have some fans out here. That's good. They're hanging out. It's a good crowd when you start off with 21,000 people.
So Tusculum will line up third and 7 here at their own 35. 6 of 14 on the afternoon. Quick snap and Foster around the left edge. Up to the 40, well shy of the first down. You can imagine here, down 52-21. As Coach DeBus just wants to add insult to injury, you expect him possibly to go for it here, as they have on a couple occasions so far, and there's a player down after the play.
Zach York on the tackle out of Hartwell, Georgia, Hart County High School, junior, six-footer. Came into tonight's game with one tackle for a loss.
A Pioneer down at the 40-yard line. The training crew from Tusculum taking a look.
Zach delivered a pretty hard hit. The conditioning, which we talked about our speed and our strength, Ryan. Pretty impressed with our conditioning so far.
I was talking with Russ last week in Birmingham, and really, to me, it's the biggest difference in this program in the last couple of years. And you saw it early on under Coach Munkin. They put a lot of emphasis on conditioning and practice. I mean, you're held the NCAA to only so much time, and you got so many things you want to do. And they put a lot of emphasis on that conditioning during the practice sets, and you're certainly seeing it pay off.
Oh, yeah, great conditioning. And
Brian Marshall was helped off by the Pioneer training crew, running back. Now on fourth and 5, Tusculum appearing to show a punt. Jonathan Bryan back deep at the Eagle 25. Rossetti kicks this one away, and a beautiful kick will send Bryant back. Over the shoulder catch at the 9, far side. Now he'll come back, get ahead of steam up the middle of the field. Right hash, breaks it outside. 25, 30, 35, trying to leap over a defender. He's down at the 40-yard line, marking down at the 41. Great return for Jonathan Bryant, and the return game has been spectacular tonight. LaRon Scott, Dominique Swope, who started the game fielding punts, and right there, Jonathan Bryant.
A great return. That's a case where your punter outkicked his coverage. Beautiful looking punt. I mean, line drive looking punt. But you got a speedster like Bryant back there, catches over his shoulder, and the first defender's a good 15, 20 yards away. He gets ahead of speed up. He's trouble.
12 minutes up on the board here in the fourth quarter, which is moving very slowly here. First down and 10 at the 41. For the Eagles offense, it'll be Jerick McKinnon once again bringing out the offense here. Split back formation. Swope, as McKinnon will keep it, or rather, his AUU will keep it. He'll get a chance at quarterback, and he goes up the middle, makes his way to the 40, and eventually stopped at the 36-yard line. So, Izzy UU getting action in the QB role here with 11:49 to play in the fourth quarter. UU, much has been talked about, almost had a change of heart here in Statesboro in the summer prior to fall camp. Mitchell, he comes back to the team. Coaches felt like he could be a great addition, not only as quarterback, but we've seen him in practice line up as a slot receiver. Talented young man. Picks up the first down, a Franklin first down. It's first down and 10 at the Tusculum 35-yard line. Uyute in that split gun takes a low snap. Hands it off to Swope, and Swope moving left to right. Stays on his feet momentarily and inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Couple of Pioneers slow to get up. We got a late flag well after the play.
It's good to see Zeke Rozier in the ballgame as well.
Izzy Uyute, 5'11", 173-pounder. Out of Wachula, Florida. As the officials meet after the late flag came out. Zeke Rozier, a man who certainly you can't deny his true blue spirit. Recruited here as a running back. Had a sensational debut game his freshman year, had a knee injury, and then has been battling to get back since then. Decided to strap on the pads one more time, and he's out there in the blue and white, number 6.
I'm not sure what just happened, folks.
No flag. They wave it off after the meeting by the officials, so it'll be second down and 3 here for the Eagle offense. The ball down at the 29-yard line of Tusculum. UU. Split gun formation with Rozier and Swope. He'll take option right side. He'll fake the pitch, cut it back inside. Will be UU. Carries a couple of Pioneers for a Franklin first down at the 20-yard line.
For a little skinny kid, runs pretty strong, doesn't he?
UU does a great job of making people miss. Very good on his feet in traffic and throws an absolutely beautiful football. Has a very good arm, does UU.
And not that it so much counts, but you always hear getting off the bus how you look. He's one of the best looking quarterbacks. He is a guy that looks like an incredible athlete.
First down and 10 now at the Tusculum red zone at the 20-yard line. Far side hash. UU redirecting Willie Burden. Burden lines up left side in that backfield. Handed off, Zeke Rozier right up the gut. Makes his way to the 15-yard line. Pick up a 5, second down and 5 for the Eagles, who are happy to see this clock roll. And we still have a ton of time, 10 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in this game, which got started right at 6 o'clock this evening. Honoring Gene Bishop at halftime. Unfortunate passing of Mr. Bishop, whose name sits atop the field house here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Of course, the alumni house just down the road. And so many gifts over the years from Gene Bishop. Second down and 5. They'll option left side. UU breaks an arm tackle. UU 10-5. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Izzy UU with his first career touchdown makes it 58-21 with an even 10 minutes to play in this game.
And this is not a case of running up the score, but like we talked about before, you can't tell a third team quarterback and running back not to try to score. That's why they're in the ball game. And a great run. We saw some excitement out of Izzy. We knew we would. It's just good to see it on the field.
Well, for a skinny kid, as you say, Terry, yeah, sure did shed that arm tackle at the five.
I'm just telling you, he runs strong.
Adrian Mora, somebody better get an ice pack ready for Adrian as he gets ready for the point after. Kick is up, and kick is good. 59-21. 10 minutes remain here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Georgia Southern now stretching its legs for the season opener. We'll take a timeout, return in just a moment. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
103.7 The Boomer. Hey, if you're headed for the Georgia Southern home game, call ahead at 685-4110 for Beverage Charhouse Grill, and they'll have everything packed up and ready to eat for those tailgate parties. Or stop in Beverage on your way to or from the big game for their delicious buffet or something special from their menu. Remember, Beverage Friday Night Seafood Buffet, all you care to eat, just $14.95. They're open early for breakfast, too, 6 a.m. Beverage Charhouse Grill at the I-16 exit Metter. Go Big Blue, go Eagles. For great deals, shop the Statesboro Flea Market off the north end of the bypass at 158 East Parish. Household items, new and used clothing, arts and crafts, antiques and collectibles, and much, much more. Browse the vendors' booths and stop by the Horsing Around Cafe or the Hair Salon, and they consign your merchandise. Don't miss the truckload sale on new outdoor furniture and patio accessories on now at Statesboro Flea Market. Call 912-536-6917. Proud supporters of GSU football.
Five plays, 59 yards, 2 minutes of the clock. Izzy, your Ute had a little coming out party here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium as he shows what all was talked about. Well, he showed he backs it up. Not only does he run very elusive runner, Chris, but he runs with a lot of strength, shedding tackles. Put an Eagle 6 on it. The Eagles go up 59-21 here at the prettiest little stadium in America.
Well, you know, when you read back and look at the history of this storied program in its 30th year in the modern age of football, this score is starting to look like many we've saw over the years as Billy Greer will kick this one away. Short kick, takes a bounce at the 14. Xavier Smith will decide to pick it up, and he is leveled at the 14-yard line.
Great tackle, great speed down there. Looked like Gilmore running down there to make the tackle.
Edwin Jackson on the tackle.
Edwin Jackson.
Along with Gilmore down there.
So Tusculum will take over. First down and 10 at their own 14-yard line. 59-21. Checking the Toyota game tracker. Georgia Southern. 44 carries on the ground, 333 yards of rushing offense, 7 of 10 through the air for 179 yards. First down and 10 at the 14, Cordell comes out slinging the football. Far side to Rodriguez, trying to find and stretch enough room on the far sideline, but not much there. Picks up 3 yards, second down and 7 upcoming. From the 17-yard line of their very own, total offense, 512 yards. But credit the Tusculum Pioneers, 340 yards of offense for the Pioneers tonight. Cordell, 32 of 49, 310 yards passing. Did have the interception, but it's thrown for 2 touchdowns tonight. Second down, 7 at the 17-yard line of their very own. Attacking left to right. Shotgun snap. Exclusive shotgun tonight for the Pioneers. Sling this one out far side to the 24-yard line. Catch hauled in. Still shy of the first down sticks.
Well, we heard coming in the ball game that Tusculum likes to throw, and I'm starting to believe that they do like, in fact, they like to throw. They throw, and they will run this, and they will run this clock, man, I tell you.
Well, we talked about the size, especially on the offensive line, but when you take a look at some of the skill players for this Tusculum team, you'll see some of the top names in high school football here in the Southeast. It's on third down and a yard. They give it off, and actually Bo Cordell will take the shotgun snap and work it across for the first down for Tusculum. But well, you can tell that Frankie DeBusk, his years at Furman, didn't lose the fact that there's some great high school football in that state.
And in all the states. Burns and Greenwood, and then you look at Flower out of Flowery Branch and a couple of schools out of Georgia. In fact, I think I remember seeing that they were more out of the state of Georgia than even Tennessee on that roster.
First down and 10 at the 26, Cordell. Stretching out the play, but now the pocket comes down, and he is dropped at the 19-yard line. He tried to buy himself time, but a good job by the Eagles not forcing or not allowing him to move the pocket left or right. He just tried to stay in and stay on his feet. But Georgia Southern will be credited with the sack with 8:07, this clock continuing to move as Rashad Williams will pick up his first sack of the season for the Eagle defense backup defensive end. Second and 18. Quick screen, far sideline. Diliberto goes nowhere. Picks up maybe 3 yards. And Georgia Southern now just happy to let them throw it around. Everything's going to stay in front of them. You saw Cordell early in the game, Terry. Throw downfield. They've kind of gotten rid of that. Trying to go with the safer short dunk and deep. And Georgia Southern not giving him any gaps or creases at all.
He burned his long a few times, of course, but we knew that we'd get some breaks on this passing game.
I am impressed with their blocking from the wide receivers, especially Michael Rodriguez. They really get after it out there.
Third and 14 at their 23-yard line. Stacked two receivers to the right, and Cordell dancing around, moves forward, now drops back, and now is dropped to the carpet. Tirico Agnew, with his beautiful singing voice, just dropped down. Bo Cordell, along with Justice Ejike. As you're seeing now, he's not able to move that pocket at all. He's got pressure in front of him and from left and right. And that sets up fourth and 22. And it looks like Andy Rossetti will stand in the shadow of the Gene Bishop Fieldhouse and try to punt this away as Jonathan Bryant will stand back deep. The Eagles expect to get great field position here, although Rossetti did send Bryant back last time with quite a boot.
Well, I know that this isn't Furman, but Frankie was the quarterback on that Furman team in 1988 when they knocked us out of the national championship, which I played against him, so it's kind of nice to get a little revenge here.
Short kick by Rossetti takes an Eagle bounce as it lands at the 45 of the Eagles. A lot of pushing and shoving down there. The ball, all by its lonesome, goes out of the far sideline. May have hit a player.
It hit the back of our heel, and another player kicked it.
So the Eagles take over, first down and 10. The officials getting together to mark the spot. It looks to be at the 44 of Tusculum with 6:55 to play. Fans, stay tuned for the Ford locker room wrap-up coming up following the play-by-play of tonight's game. Russ Brown, Ryan Chambers, defensive coach Vic Cabral will be here with us. Be happy to take your questions via the social networks at GA Southern Radio. That's Twitter.
Oh, yeah.
At GA Southern Radio. And, of course, at the Georgia Southern Facebook page.
And Coach Cabral said, give him any questions. He's happy to take them. He wanted to plug his own Twitter site, which I told him would be
Of course,
fine.
You know how big Vic is. I'd be careful with those questions still. He'll hunt you down.
6:55 to play, and they'll mark it up. Now it's placed down at the 47-yard line of Tusculum. Again, split back formation. Now Ute's going to throw deep down the far sideline. One-on-one coverage and pass interference will be the call. And I told you Ute has a pretty throw, and he was looking for Contrellis Showers down the far sideline. And that one, a beautiful arc on that pass from Izzy Ute.
Wow.
That was nice. And that's one to let folks know that he can throw the ball, future defenses. And Ryan, that may be a response to some of the jawing you were talking about earlier.
Yeah, could be. I've been wondering how this would be handled inside of 10 minutes if it got as out of hand as I thought it might get.
So pass interference is the call.
And, you know, for 21,000 that have paid their hard-earned money to be here, you know, I mean, why let it go now? Let's keep going. I know, Terry, you're a big advocate for that.
Well, on the penalty, it is a Franklin first down, and sets the Eagles up. First down and 10 now with the ball placed at the 32-yard line of the Pioneers. Again, Ute, split gun. Ute taking out right side. Ute decides to keep. Drop down at the 26-yard line. Nice pickup for Izzy on the run. 6:38 to go in the fourth quarter.
I would be interested, and I might even ask Coach Cabral this, even though it's an offensive question. I don't know, as obviously as much about the option, but I would think it would be common for a young guy to keep a lot going around the end, not certain for that pitch. I'd imagine you probably see that a lot of the guys that are new getting under center, and you've seen you keep it a lot here since he checked in the ball game.
Second down four at the Tusculum 27. Far side hash, shotgun snap. Again, UU will take it left side. UU on the carpet. Believe the ball came loose after he was down. It did come loose, but the officials blow the whistle immediately as UU dropped at the 20-yard line. A pickup of about 7 yards. It stood stand for enough for another Franklin first down. While we have a moment, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football on the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Follow the Eagles all season on 103.7 The Boomer, WBNZ, Metter Statesboro, Swainsboro, the official flagship station of Georgia Southern Athletics.
Back inside the Verizon broadcast booth with 5:59 to go in the game. 59-21, Georgia Southern leading over Tusculum, and Uyut on the carry before the last play. And ball came out as he hit the 16-yard line, and now the officials huddling up to talk about it. It appeared they ruled it down. Couldn't be caused by the field. He was already down, certainly sliding with his knees. And now Coach Munkin, I think, wanting an indication of where they will mark him down is the biggest question at this point, as Coach DeBusk is out on the far sideline, right off the line judge's ear.
I believe they're calling this a fumble, gentlemen, and that we retain
the
ball.
I was down on this side, and the whistle definitely blew, so I know the coaching staff's going to have a little bit of a little irritation at that.
I think they're ruling it a fumble, and we're getting the first down of it, and they're spotting the ball where the fumble was recovered by our guy. We wisely jumped on the ball, but they're calling it as of right now, unless they change their minds again.
Well, Frankie DeBusk is lobbying on his behalf. He's not happy at all, very animated on that far sideline. So now our referee, after getting an earful from Coach DeBus, Thomas Graham, is ready to set the clock and get moving. 5:55, and the clock begins to move. 59-21 our score. Georgia Southern in the lead, looking to go 2-0 on the season, and 1-0 here at the friendly confines of Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Now up under center is Uyut on first down and 10 at the Tusculum 18-yard line. He can't handle the snap. He'll decide to scoop it up, try to move forward, but Tusculum will push him back to the 25.
That was a great play by the Tusculum defensive, the linebacker there, who timed his blitz perfectly, right the snap, drilled our center back into Izzy, and that caused the fumble. Wisely, he held on to it. That would be our fifth fumble on the night. We've lost one.
5:17 clock moving. Again, thanks to all of our radio affiliates across the state of Georgia, many of them joining us here for the home opener at Allen E. Paulson Stadium.
Yeah, I saw Seth in the box, by the way, out of Savannah.
Second down, 17 at the 25. Willie Burton, the tight end in motion. Back to the split gun, is Uyut. Out to the right side. Pitch it comes. It's Devin Scott. And Devin Scott down the far sideline, inside the 10, near the sticks. A whole lot of traffic over there. Well-executed option play for the Georgia Southern offense, and it appears, no indication as of yet, Thomas Graham eyes the sticks, and it will be second and short on the pickup for Devin Scott, a 16-yard gain with 4:43 to play.
As Brent Thomas comes into the ball game, and what's so huge about this, guys, is last year we didn't really have that luxury of a second and third quarterback. I'm thinking we might have that now.
Three quarterbacks used in tonight's game. Jay Beauchamp with the start. We'll give you his numbers on the Toyota game tracker. He was 6 of 9 through the air, 181 yards tonight. As the Eagles will keep it on the ground, giving it off to Brent Thomas. The fullback hit right at the line. Stopped at about the line of scrimmage, maybe lost half a yard.
Bring up fourth down.
A long two here as Adrian Mora and Charlie Edwards, I believe, will trot onto the field to try for the field goal here with under 4 minutes to play. But Jay Beauchamp tonight, many people said it wasn't his greatest game in the opener last week. But tonight, pretty good job. 6 of 9 passing, 181 yards, and a throwing touchdown. Mora will try the 26-yarder. Hash mark right. Kick is up. Kick is good. Adrian Mora makes it 62-21 with 3:38 to go in this game. We'll take a timeout. We'll return. Georgia Southern rolling up Tusculum on a Saturday night, 62-21. Eagles lead. You're listening to the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Okay, it's game day, where tradition runs deeper than your Aunt Betty's baked beans. Face paint? Check. Cooler? Check. Meat for the grill? Check. Ford F-150 with best-in-class towing, payload, and a V6 EcoBoost engine delivering 22 mpgs. Check, check, and check. Now check this. Go to shopfordnow.com to find great offers on F-150 from your local Ford dealer. Fans of Georgia Southern football. EPA estimated 16 city, 22 highway mpg, 3.5 liter V6, 4x2.
CEOs and agents of change, educators, entrepreneurs, artists, attorneys, and the scientists who helped send the first man to the moon. Our professions and paths are unique, but we all have something in common. We are graduates of Georgia Southern University. I'm Connell Stafford, class of 1970. I am an alum. Support our alma mater by becoming a member of Georgia Southern Alumni Association. Go to alumni.georgiasouthern.edu.
Your gas up and tailgate supply needs, it's Neighbors Express convenience stores with locations in Statesboro in front of Lowe's, also in Sylvania, and exit 51 in Dublin. On your way to the heart of Eagle Nation, choose to do business with those that are true blue. Choose Neighbors Express convenience stores. Georgia Southern kicking off to Tusculum with 3:38 to go in the game. Jonathan Deliberto will field it at the 9 near side, come up the right hash, and then runs into a wall at the 30. Had a little bit of room, and then got tattooed with blue. Carlos Cave made the stop with help from special teams, and with 3.5 minutes to go in the game, 62-21. Georgia Southern adding to the score on an Adrian Mora field goal.
Six plays, 39 yards, 3 minutes and 17. Is he running the offense to perfection? One hiccup with a little bit of a bobbled snap there. Got to see Devin Scott on the play, and we got to see what Izzy's arm strength looks like. The long pass down the sideline, pass interference, which calls for quick Southern Conference scores in the fourth quarters. Chattanooga 31, Jacksonville State 17. Western Carolina over Mars Hill 52-17.
Tusculum brings it out. Kyle Dickey in at quarterback, in relief of Bo Cordell, who may be finished for the day, we expect. Get this, air raid, you say? 35 of 52 passing today for Bo Cordell. 321 yards, 2 touchdowns. He did have an interception back in the first half, but boy, that guy has to have a sore right arm when this is all over with. But he's been accustomed to it as a junior and a Harlan Hill candidate. Second down, 6 for the Pioneers. It'll be B.J. Spradlin on the handoff across the 35 to about the 36. Only about a yard gain. It'll set up 3rd and 5. Justice Ajike again, the out of Covington, Georgia.
And also, Reckers into the ballgame. Zach Reckers, junior out of Atlanta, Georgia, on the last 2 tackles as well. The solo last tackle. This time he was on with the assist.
3rd down, 6 at the 36-yard line. Kyle Dickey in a shotgun. Spradlin on a wing to his right. Dickey in the pocket. Chase and brought down at the 28-yard line. Michael Butler in the offensive backfield once again will be credited with the sack. Now we're down approaching 2 minutes and 9 seconds. His third sack of the night for Michael Butler, and that'll be 4th down and 12 upcoming for the Pioneers.
Appalachian State demolishing North Carolina A&T 58-6.
You think they were upset about last week's game in Blacksburg?
I think so. Samford woke up in 42-6 in the third quarter over Stillman. Elon 35, Concord 7.
Andy Rossetti again back to punt for Tusculum. Stands at his 15-yard line with 1:42 to play. Get this one away. High kick. Bryant back deep. Call for the fair catch and fielded at the 29-yard line of the Eagles. So with 1:34 to go, we've got some join and a little mix-up over there. Now a late flag coming out from the line judge near side as Tusculum starting to show frustration here in the 62-21 game. And now whistles and flags trying to have cooler heads prevail.
Yeah, and the line judge over here might have thrown, there was a little bit of a pushing block into the face on Thomas at the end, and afterwards just continue the taunting as he was coming off the field. I don't know if that's where they threw it. That's where he threw it towards. I don't know if that's what the call is. But a little frustration here.
Problem with the official's mic here tonight at times.
Yep. That's what it was. It was called against that one player who continued to jaw as he went off the field of play. It's unfortunate for Coach Frankie over there that his guys are this part. And not a stat he's going to be happy with now. That would be the 10th penalty on the night and 100 yards worth of penalties against Tusculum.
Skylar West, I believe, Skylar West Newport, a junior, whistled for the infraction. It's now first down and 10. At the 44-yard line, Eagles set up in the victory formation. UU take the snap and lost his footing, but he does come to the ground, and the play is halted as he's down at the 40-yard line. Gets the clock moving. 1 minute, 25 seconds till the Eagles can call themselves a 2-0 team here in 2011. Again, the Eagles off next week. The off week coming week number 3 before coming back here to Alan E. Paulson Stadium to take on Western Carolina. As Terry told you, got the win tonight over Mars Hill. Down to 1 minute remaining in the game. Eagles ready to once again line up victory formation. As Gilmore and Devin Scott protect Izzy UU. He'll take the snap and take a knee. And with 45 seconds in the clock moving, one more play shall do it. Georgia Southern starts to celebrate. The fans remaining here at Paulson Stadium now on their feet with applause for the Eagles. It's going to be interesting to hear Coach Jeff Munkin. Ryan Chambers will catch him in the Ford locker room wrap-up. His thoughts on the game, not the prettiest at times, although very effective when protecting the football. As with 17 seconds, this should be the final snap. UU will take the snap. With 8 seconds to go on the game clock, takes the knee, and that will be all she wrote. Final 3 seconds, roll off the clock. The horn sounds, and this one's in the books. Georgia Southern with the win, 62-21 over the Pioneers of Tusculum in the first ever meeting between these two schools, and the Eagles off to a 2-0 start, while the Pioneers fall to 1-1. 62-21, our final score. We've got plenty left this evening. Coming up, the Ford Locker Room Wrap-Up presented by your Georgia Neighborhood Ford dealers. We'll have all the highlights, all the first half and second half stats, as well as a chance to hear from a couple of Eagles, the Knox defensive pest of the game. We'll have the Verizon call of the game and a word with Eagle head coach Jeff Munkin, who now has his team off to a 2-0 start here in 2011 with a win tonight over Tusculum. Final score, Georgia Southern 62, the Tusculum Pioneers 21. We'll return to Alan E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. This is Georgia Southern football.
Welcome into the Ford Locker Room Wrap-Up, presented by your Georgia Ford dealers on the Georgia Southern Radio Network. Ford Drive One.
Oh, two is more than 21. Welcome back to the prettiest little stadium in America. Great outing for the Eagles, up and down at times. The offense had several drives that were like 4 plays, 2 minutes long, big time scores. And then we saw some hiccups. But at the end of the night, 62 is a lot more than 21 in Eagle Nation. Be very much pleased to be 2-0 with this start, because we came out today and did what we were supposed to do. Welcome back, Eagle fans, to the prettiest little stadium in America. Georgia Southern knocks off Tusculum. Non-conference ball game after going to Birmingham last week on the road, performing well in the second half. Much of the same tonight. We got off to a good start. A few glitches along the way. Soon Ryan Chambers will be with us as he gets a chance to talk to the coach, with Russell Brown, as we talk to the defensive Knox defensive coach for plays of the game. Right now, our team, our players, are standing in front of Southern Pride as tradition. So we're going to go pay tribute to our sponsors real quick and be right back. You're listening to the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Okay. It's game day, where tradition runs deeper than your Aunt Betty's baked beans. Face paint? Check. Cooler? Check. Meat for the grill? Check. Ford F-150 with best-in-class towing, payload, and a V6 EcoBoost engine delivering 22 mpgs. Check, check, and check. Now check this. Go to shopfordnow.com to find great offers on F-150 from your local Ford dealer. Fans of Georgia Southern football. EPA estimated 16 city, 22 highway and BG, 3.5 liter V6, 4x2.
Careful you're not like, Mr. It Can't Happen to Me, thinking heart disease is for other people. Because heart disease can happen to anyone, even you. If it does, remember East Georgia Regional is where you'll find life-saving specialists and services available locally. And that can make all the difference in a cardiac emergency. But don't take our word for it. Read our patient stories or submit your own at eastgeorgiaregional.net.
Harold promised his 7-year-old son, CJ, that he would build him a fort. That's why Georgia Power wants to be the official energy partner of keeping Harold's promise. Not only will we help Harold build that fort by supplying the reliable electricity he'll need, but we'll give him a blueprint to fortify his home and help save energy. It's called EarthSense. With EarthSense, he'll find energy savings he didn't know he had, and he can get hundreds of dollars back in rebates when he makes energy efficiency improvements to his home. To learn more about EarthSense, go to georgiapower.com. Georgia Power, official energy.